think I just went live at 7 on the dot. For the first time in my life. Right. Hello, hello. Hopefully everyone can hear me. I'm going to give you a couple minutes to gather yourselves and such. I'm going to pick some music. I have to ban the Manchester United support, though. That's unacceptable. Is this tracking my... It is, yeah. Just bear with me. I'm just gonna do something very quickly. Anyways, hello. It is... I'm very tired. I'm gonna put that out right now. I initially cancelled tonight because I have slept for about an hour. My plan was to, you know, fix my sleep. And can I post this video? Oh, I can, sweet. Sorry, I'm just doing something and you can't see my monitor for secret reasons. Right, that should be good. Let's bring PK back up. Yeah, I haven't really slept. Which is why I was going to cancel today. I had a video done for tonight. But, I napped like an hour or something. An hour or two. And I feel alright. So, I figured we'll do it and then the video can go up tomorrow. Instead, why is that wet? What's going on? Everything's wet. And I know I kind of have that effect, but... Alright. I got my music. I have my juice. Juice, not deuce. I have everything I need. Right. So, it might be a short stream today because I say I am shattered, but I've got energy drinks in the fridge if absolutely need be. I want to do like a long stream at some point soon. I want to do like maybe a charity thing for like Palestine or something like that. Try to raise a bit of money. Do like a 24-hour stream or something. It's not double N, it's single N. Shameful behaviour. Right. Let me turn my music down. It's a fun, my God, my favourite song of all time, right here. Actually, I'm gonna re-listen to the whole thing. Right, so in the last video, we moved from our woodland wilderness with our gigantic skull and our arthropleura. And we moved into our opening area sort of thing. It's a little bit wild, I'm not going to pretend otherwise. These trees are driving me absolutely bonkers. So we're just going to move them to there for now so the shadows stop annoying me. So this is the entrance, inverted commas, to the park. It's not really a park. Now, of course... PK is updated this week. If you didn't see my video on Monday, we have tons of new cool stuff. All Stone Age themed, and of course that means new animals as well. I don't think any of this is going to be that relevant, unfortunately, for a little while. I was talking about this on the PK video, and someone gave me a suggestion on how to integrate this, and I think the idea is going to be at some point, it's not going to be anytime soon, but at some point in the park, you know, this is, it's kind of a park, kind of a research facility. I haven't really decided where that's going to land, but I think the idea is going to be like a dig site kind of thing. You know, they were digging up the area and they stumbled upon some like artifacts or maybe like a cave system, and we could have this underground cave system with our cave lions and all that kind of jazz. That's kind of the idea. The wall beside the dino gate is missing a lip at the bottom. The wall beside the dino gate. Oh, it is, yeah. Well spotted. It's a weird sentence, isn't it? The wall beside the dino gate is missing a lip at the bottom. They say that to all the boys. There you go. Well noticed. Right, so... the idea for this video is we're going to finish this area off, hopefully. That means... destroying the walls a little bit, getting lots of foliage in here, more tents and stuff like that. We're going to build a vehicle, probably. We're going to do our infection thing, or like our tunnel kind of thing is the idea as well. I'm not really sure where to start. I'm a little bit... There's a lot to do today, so already I'm a little bit... Well, you know, it's like... I might have one of these walls falling inwards and breaking. Right, let me move these to the right a little bit. My beloved tents from last video. Ooh, with a view in the window, what the hell? So these are going to be our... So the idea is that we've got the quarantine, we've got like the CDC. What are they called again? It's called the... Oh, I've moved them. The CHC, the Center for Hugo Control. And that's on one side, and on the other side we're going to have these sort of slightly army-tinted kind of tents instead. Something like that. We'll just do a couple of these. And then we are going to build a vehicle. And we're going to build some other things. And then we're going to throw our coelophysis in here, is the idea. The idea is that this area has kind of fallen into disarray, and the coelophysis is here as it's a scavenger, essentially, you know, picking apart the corpses left behind by the CHC, is the idea. I'm gonna have a drink. The foliage is just gonna be the same as this stuff. I'm thinking I'm gonna have like the hill maybe come out there. I don't really know. I need to block the sides of the foliage, but that's a spooky thing. So, the big challenge for today, really, these are probably too green, is to try and build a vehicle. I think that's better. And it is going to be a little obnoxious, and I don't know if it's going to look any good, but we're going to try. Is there a wheel? No. Devs, if you're watching, I need a wheel, okay? Look, you've already made one. Just give me this as a standalone prop. I know it's not like high quality, but bloody hell, I'd take it. Right, so I've got like an image of a military kind of truck. And that's going to sit along. We're going to have maybe a couple of those sitting along here. And then there's going to be a pile of burning bodies in the corner. You know, like a standard Dinosaur Park build. CHC is the center of Hugo control. Don't ask questions about the law. The law? We're working on the law. It's one of those things that develops over time. Right. I'm not looking forward to this, I'm not going to lie. But I've built vehicles before. Successfully. Ish. So, let's try to build a truck. Pray for me. I don't remember how... Wait. I've got a plan. Let me, thinking about it, could I not... If I take my Wrangler... And I scale... Let's just give this a go. Wait, if I take my Wrangler and I scale it up... And then maybe... Extend the back? I think we could get... I think this is fine, you know? We'll make some edits, obviously. We have to do some colour changes, but I think that might work. I'm gonna give it bigger tyres. Change the coloration. Elongate the back, get rid of the seats, enclose the front. Let's give that a go. I think that's a good idea. Although we have a problem now that I need to recoloring this thing is gonna be a nightmare. What if I just do that? Yeah, okay, that's better. You know, already it's not terrible. This is the plan. This is the plan. Because I was not looking forward to building this truck, if I'm totally honest. It was going to be hard work. And I'm not down for that. So let's get rid of some of the... I mean, I put so much work in the tyres and stuff like that. Let's get rid of some of these things. I mean, I've already done all the work, right? We may as well... It was silly not to utilise it. It's not lazy. It's working harder, not smarter. Wait, no. Wait, the other way around. What's going on here? You're going to be a little disaster, aren't you, buddy? Yes, you are. grab all these tires if possible. Make them. I don't know what I'm going to do about the text. They're not easy to work with. Hey, just do a little work on it. I mean, I think it looks pretty good already, so yeah, I'm down for this. My problem is I can't grab. For example, I can't grab this middle one. These little middle bits. Which one's this, for example? Like, I want to grab the center circle, but I can't. I just can't seem to do so. But if I. There we go. Right, we need to at least change the text because it's sticking out like a sore thumb. And that says BFG. I'm going to do like a Roald Dahl story, apparently. In retrospect, when I made my. Bear with me, it's there. I didn't know the game had this though. This is actually quite useful. When you click in the same spot, it tabs through everything that's in that spot. Which is pretty sweet, actually. I didn't know that was a thing. Oops. It's got a lovely texture. So look at this scratched kind of texture. I didn't realize that was. Oh, that was great. My extra little details I put in are really paying off already. Look, Jeep. I think we maybe want to grab some of the side bits like this. This is going to take a little bit of time, but at the end of the day, it's going to be much quicker than it would have been. Let's grab some of these bits and change the color on these so it's not quite so homogeneous. Let's get rid of that. The wheel arches, stuff like that. The fuel thingamajiggy. And back around again the other way. I'm going to misclick at some point. I'm going to lose everything I've clicked on. And I can see it happening a million miles away. Life is pain. Don't tell anyone. Right. Something like that kind of thing there. Do the same with this. And maybe this one under here as well. Did I do that one over there? I did, yeah. I think if I change that bit, it's gonna look weird. Get in there. Get some wine. I approve. I'm not really a wine drinker, but I still very much approve. And what I'm gonna do, because I can't grab. Oh wait, if I just the clicking! The clicking is magical! Man, PK, I was not familiar with your game. I really wasn't. Oh no, it's got a weird button effect. Oh no, that's gonna be a pain. Okay, I'm gonna do my other plan. And my easier plan is to simply replace this with another circle. So if I was a circle, where would I be? Question we must all ask ourselves when the time comes. When the bad men come. Let's flan it. I'm just going to move this over and then we'll just stick this at each side and we've kind of just done the same thing anyway, so. Big brain. Average size brain, at the very least. Slightly problematic. We do need to make it roughly the correct size. Come here. There we go. Just so it's not just black. You can drink at work. Yeah, I didn't realize. I'm sure it's not brand new, this clicking thing. I just never knew it was a thing. It's a revelation for me. It really is. Every building game in history needs to integrate this because it's a very, very clever idea. This hasn't really worked. I need to kill. Oh my god. I like it, but you know what? It'd be even better if when I clicked on an area, it defaulted to the one that's like clearly most forward. You know what I mean? Pretend I said good words there. Oh, nope. Come here, buddy. There we go, it's more like it. Sort of. Let's get you into position. I feel like the angle might be off. And then one more on the other side. I'll have to change the tire on the back that I just saw. 99% sure that angle is way off. Jesus died a Jew. It's a song I'm listening to, by the way. I'm not just saying that for no apparent reason. Right, lovely. Nice. This makes me think of Bigfoot. It looks like Bigfoot. Not the whole build, the text. Oh, I'm gonna have to kill this as well. Jurassic Kingdom, pshaw. I'm much more serious here. People are dying, goddammit. Extending the back is gonna be a pain. Now that I think about it, maybe what I should have done is kill the tires. And then, because I want to basically stretch. I need to think. Maybe I don't want to stretch. I do want to stretch. I don't know what I want to do. Life is very confusing. I think I'm going to stretch this, and it's going to look stupid. And then we'll fix it. Maybe. Oh, I don't know. Let me change the color on this one at least. Do I have to change it? Is it not okay? It's not really fit for purpose, is it? I really wish I'd had the tires on like a separate thing, because what I want to do is raise the whole vehicle up. Maybe I should delete the tires. I think they're the thing that's kind of getting in my way right now. If I just move a tire. Oh yeah, this is fine. This is much easier than I thought it was going to be. We're going to delete the tires and we'll move them back in a minute. Means I can get rid of all this silly text as well. We're military! We don't brand our tyres. You blimmin' liberals or something, I don't know. So, how's everyone doing anyway? It's Friday. Is that important somehow? I don't know. Fridays don't really mean anything to me if I'm totally honest, but it's Friday. It's probably exciting to someone. What are your weekend plans, YouTube? What are you doing with your lives? Than spending your Friday night watching me build trucks on Prehistoric Kingdom. Other than that, what are you doing with your lives? Not that there's anything wrong with that, obviously. Quite the opposite. I'll kill this one as well. Okay, and we're going to kill the back seats. The front seats can stay because they're where the men sit, the men who are here to take you away. This is really based on Doctor Who, on the episode where the Master takes over and everyone gets deported. You had a good day at school. I'm glad. Dungeons and Dragons, very nice. How do I spell tire? Would I spell it T-I-R-E or would I spell it T-Y? I'd spell T-I-R-E. Right, so the idea is I want to elongate this. I think that's going to be trickier than I... No. Come here. Thank you. If I do that... Oh, no, this is... this might be okay. This might be okay. I think we're cooking with gas, folks. Oh, what's going on there, though? Right, let's grab this here. Ignore what it's done to the tire arches. They can be fixed. Move that into position. I'm going to move the tire arches back. At least that was the plan. If I grab both sides, it should fix that weird little angular issue we've got going on there. Lovely jubbly. Oh, no, wrong. Oh, okay. Oh, no. work. Bear with me, folks. I'm just gonna delete them. We can build it again. We'll make more better tire arches. Okay, so now what we can do is just kind of elongate these bits out, and hopefully make our truck big and wide, which is, you know, always a benefit, in my opinion. Pretty sure that's sticking out way at the front. This is a little bit easier than I expected it to be, so let's just wait for something to go terribly wrong, I suppose. The problem is, as I move things, things are getting pushed into slightly strange positions. Suddenly I see... It looks a little bit boring. We can add some detail, though. And also, I'd love to... no, that's... I'm not going to bother with that. We'll elongate this around... There's more detail on one side than there's the other. Want that little bit to stick out. And then, why does this one on the right kind of have a door area? I'm going to say this is a... Oh, we don't really want a door, do we? What am I doing with my life? I'm in that position again where, like, both sides are so different from each other, and I don't know why. I don't know why I've done it like this. It doesn't make any sense to me why I would build it like this in the first place, you know? Like, why are they not the same? That's wild to me. I'm just gonna move some things around until they look a bit more symmetrical. Okay, right, let's raise the whole thing. And then we're gonna turn the back... this into a, Okay. So we're gonna shrink this down. Oh no, see, I've just done too much detail, that's the issue, really. I'm too talented. It's a constant problem. But I want to make this look like a panel that would flip down. I suppose we just change the colour, that might do it. Why is that not changing? Oh, it's because I'm a silly. Oh my god, what have I done? Let's try that again. Kind of got a panel here. If we just kind of duplicate this, shrink it down. Just need a little bit that stands out, just so it looks like it could be a thing. You know, that's the bit that flips down and, you know, you get in the back of the truck. Basically.
Little globe icon in the middle.
Oh, yeah, I know. I do that fairly often. It wasn't working with the, if you see what I mean, if I grab this. It's, the angle isn't... It's not on the grid, basically, so it doesn't work. I might go dark on that instead. I should have built it on the grid, obviously. That would have been the logical thing to do, but that's neither here nor there. Let's just make that a little bit... Like that, okay. Right. Let me move this tire into place. Actually, let's duplicate it and then move it into place. Make it a little bit bigger. Big, chunky tires. Oh, no, daddy, don't go. I really like this song, but again, it's that bit with the bloody crying baby. Ruins everything. Crying babies ruin everything. We'll have to thicken up the front a little bit as well. We'll hang some stuff off it. It's taken a little bit longer than I thought it was going to, but I will say it's definitely still quicker than the alternative. So, I got that going for me. Right. So, let's finish off this. These are tire arches. It's this bit in the song. Good job, daddy! Good job, daddy! Shut up. God damn. And I sound like a lunatic. I'm aware of that. You can't hear what I'm listening to. Some of your boys are Ripley gone and take care of your brother. Something like that. I think you should have six tires on a military vehicle. I'm not sure why. Just, you know, psychologically. It's intimidating. I know that I'm more intimidated by vehicles that have either more tires or less tires. Four tires is like the least scary number of tires, you know. But what is the scariest number of tires? That is the question. These are just so not symmetrical. You know, if a truck is approaching, it's got like seven tires. That feels a little disconcerting. At some point, you have too many tires, and it's not scary anymore because it's just like, you know, it's a little bit absurd. You know, if a truck rolls up, it's got 7,000 tires. Like, well, that's a lot of tires. But I'm assuming you've got tires just to intimidate me, so I'm not scared anymore. You know what I mean? You know what I mean. Everybody knows exactly what I mean. So, hush, little baby, you're driving me crazy. Why are you so sloppy? So incredibly sloppy. I really, really cheaped out on these tire arches. That was like, why? Like, why have you moved? Get back in position. I think I didn't bring them all across. I'm just gonna do a little bit of tidying up over here because that is pretty unacceptable by my standards. My standards are low, so it's pretty bad. It's better than, oh my god, what has gone on over it? Like, how has this happened? It was fine a second ago, wasn't it? You're never alone. Exciting news, folks. I don't know if I've talked about this on the channel. It's kind of news since last video, I suppose. But I am moving in May and buying my own house. A little worried because YouTube's a little bit finicky right now. I'm not going to lie, like, things aren't necessarily going that well. You know, I'm able to do it because my dad is very graciously helping me out with my deposit. I've managed to scramble some money together myself. But, oh, these are very tight. Right, you're going to have to get shrunk down a little bit. Much to my sadness. But it will be the first time in my life I actually... Right, these keep changing colour. I swear to God, I've made these black 7,000 times. Yeah, it'll be the first time in my life I've owned a house. It's exciting times. I've never had... Like, my studio has always been my bedroom. I've been a professional YouTuber for 13 years. 14 years or something ridiculous. There are people watching my channel who are younger than my channel. And, I've never had a studio. At no point have I ever had a studio. I've always recorded in my bedroom every single time. Absolutely ridiculous. So that's definitely one of the things I'm excited to change, have a dedicated studio space. Hopefully start doing more, you know, I can do product reviews and stuff like that a lot easier when I've got a dedicated setup. I'm gonna have to change some things up this year. What is going on with this white text? But yeah, exciting times. Nerve-wracking times, but exciting times. Do I want to keep the... Nah, that's fine, it's fine. Kill my AU. I've got some ideas, some stuff I want to do. I'm going to do some slightly different content on the channel this year. We'll see how things go. You fit in there, tight squeeze, but that's okay. We're kind of used to that. Let's get that in there, lovely jubbly. Now, unfortunately, wait, no, you're a tiny baby tire. Wait one sec, let me just move this one across instead. Odrich. We're going to pretend like, you know, because obviously some of the text has been deleted. Some of it hasn't. We'll just pretend it's a weird brand. Odrich, well known for their military-grade tires. It would surprise you the companies involved in the military. You know, it's like, oh, we make fridges and we also make weapons of mass destruction, you know? I'm not going to pretend, by the way, this is the most realistic vehicle the world has ever seen. It just has to give the right impression. Will I be painting you on the wall? I'm not building a tank. I don't think I'm building a tank. I know, Zala. Trust me when I say I would not be able to have... I wouldn't have been able to buy a house without some help. It's actually not a bad time to buy a house because... it's just I was going to have to rent otherwise. And, you know, buying a house is a bit of a nightmare, sure. But I tell you what, renting is much worse. So, like, if I end up paying, like, say, £550 for a mortgage, the equivalent rent on a £550 mortgage property for me, the equivalent rent is, like, £800 to £900. You just get so much less for your money if you're renting. Which makes sense, it's just a pain in the ass. I'm gonna maybe make this less... I don't know. I want it to have a curve to it, but not too much. I think... what do I want? I never know. I want it to feel a little less curvy, because that's... Again, curves aren't intimidating. That's a well-known phenomenon. I'm just gonna... It looks alright! It's a bit weird. But, I wish I'd... It's a bit late for it now, but I wish I'd, Oh, I really do wish I had. Oh, god damn it. Let me think. How much of a pain in the ass would this be? What I want to do is I want to... It's too skinny, the whole thing. So what I need to do is... I'm just going to move the tires. I think we can... Let's make the tires separate. Oh, why don't I just do that? That makes more sense. Will you stop? What are you doing? I need to kill these A's because they're haunting me. It's only the A as well. It is only the A that's doing it. They keep reverting colour. They hate me. What's going on? I'm haunted. Right, we're just gonna stretch the truck upwards and hope that looks okay. That's the idea. It's gonna look silly, but maybe it won't. Down with the A's, my god. I watched let me check chat first. Nice little house in the middle of the house. We're very different people. I want a house or an apartment even. The problem is leasehold versus freehold. I wanna live right in the middle of the city. I'm a city boy at heart and I always have been. And I'm just not a country boy. I mean, I grew up on farms and stuff like that, but I've spent plenty of time in the country. It's just... I like noise. I like people. I like the action. You know? Right, I think this is going to look really weird, but we're going to give it a go. What I'd like to do, actually, if I can, let me just get this. What if we just... Right. Grab the whole thing. Move it up. Grab just the lower half, if possible. Which isn't really possible. You see, the angle is... Maybe I can, We're just building a monster truck instead. Let me think about this. Okay, what we're going to do... We're going to grab this. What I want to do is rotate it so it's sitting on the, is this even possible? Yeah, maybe. I want to rotate it so that it's sitting on the grid, basically, so that when I stretch it like this, you see it's got this weird angle? That's what I've got to try to get rid of. I don't really have a better idea than this. If I just do the whole thing... See what I mean? It's kind of deforming in a weird angle. It's alright. I didn't need it to be... Yeah, I think that's better, actually. You know what? I think we kind of got away with that. Weirdly enough. I'm gonna make some slight moves. I just wanted it to be a little bit taller, you know? was about to explain what I mean. it's just that is the curse of being a YouTuber, honestly, because you have to talk constantly. You end up just saying the most tedious bullshit because you have to fill the silence, and I feel so awkward. People, I remember being in the car with my ex-girlfriend, Sean, and we were driving back for a long time from somewhere, and it was the first time she'd been in the car with me and my family. And we're not like a small talk family at all. We just don't do it. We're not very good at it. Me and my dad are okay because we'll basically, me and my dad get in the car together, we talk about football for about half an hour, and then we stop talking. That's the general rule. So it's just not something we're built to do. But her family was crazy talkative, and I remember how surprised she was sitting in the car with us, and us basically not saying a word to each other. She couldn't believe it. Anyways, I had a point to make here. I can't remember what it was. But, oh yeah, my point is that even though I essentially just talk non-stop nonsense for a living, maybe that's why in my personal life I don't. Unless you get me talking about something. Unless I get drunk. Or I'm talking about something I really care about. But I'm not a small talk guy. How did this take so long when I was adapting an existing vehicle? I ask you. I need to change this. This is stupid. It looks good though. I'm quite happy with it. I'll stick on the workshop. These tires are floating. Is that a problem? Eh. We can pretend that one's flat. It's fine. So I don't want to do too much more with this because I'm bored. I'm just going to make some small changes. For example, that, which I think was designed to cover the wheel arches. Actually, I'm going to make that go all the way along now. You see how every time I move something, this is dropped, as you can see. And it's also shifted to the side. Just because everything's on, nothing's on the grid, essentially. So every time you shift things along, they all move in different weird ways. Got a hug today. That's nice. Living the dream. Yeah, I guess we'd go beige for the seats. Oh, I mean, I have to grab the seats again. It's making me do extra work. I know your game. Round my body. Ocean burn. Ah! right, if I was brown. No, that's a weird sentence. I don't want it to have a lot of colour. I'll tell you what, like, look, this is white, right? You would think it would get darker. I mean, it does get darker, but look at how long it takes. Like, halfway down, that's the change. You have to go all the way to here to get into... Like, what I'm saying is they're very bright by default, I suppose, is what I'm trying to say. I know it's very exciting, I just thought I'd tell you. The problem is, the lighter they are as well, the more you see the stupid little details. right. So I want to add, like, some slats along here, because this is it's for ferrying people around at the end of the day. And the people aren't allowed to escape. What is going on? Why have you... Right, no, stop. Stop. We're just going to throw in... Just be on the shape. I'll do. So these are going to just sit along the side. Keep out the... it's kind of... Inspired by Doctor Who. It's also kind of inspired by the start of Skyrim. Not really. Got to keep the sickies in. That's the idea. So let's change these up color-wise as well. What color do you want to be, buddy? I want to be this color. Whoa, don't do that. That's weird. That'll do. Also, I haven't talked about it yet, but it's worth remembering that Liverpool won the Carabao Cup this weekend. Well, this week. I just think it's important that we recognise that, you know? For the good of the people. I wouldn't want you to think that I'm ignoring it. I know how much you all care. See, now that should be on the, that should match perfectly because I've added the extra object and based it on the side of the vehicle. I got that little glass on there as well, not nice fancy. And we need to block off back here. Actually, I might, maybe need to move. Okay, let me think about this. What am I thinking? I never really know. Oh yeah, should we chat more? Sorry. Do you think there should be a variant for the Velociraptor in the game that's scaly instead of feathery? I guess. I am a little surprised there isn't, I suppose, just because, you know, we've got like a furry Pachyrhinosaurus, for example. So why not a scaly Velociraptor? But, I mean, if they were going to do that with anything, I'd rather it be with like a Deinonychus or something like that anyway. If we're going to, because clearly the idea, you know, you want a little bit of a Jurassic Park inspo in there, right? But the raptor is never going to look like that just because of its size and morphology, so. I know these are going to be too close to the front, but I don't really have a choice, so. No leg room for you. You're a military man. Get over it. Because what I need to do, you can't have the people in charge exposed to the rabble, you know what I mean? So I just need to put in a bit of a... I thought I'd done that. Bit of a dividing line in here. I promised dinosaurs in my dinosaur park. I'm very aware of that. I'm keenly aware that I promised that. We will get there. We will. Eventually. I'll do. And let's put some glass. Actually, what I might do is just. What shape? Oh, you're a fun shape. In the dark. It has to not look like. I don't think it looks like the Jurassic Park truck anymore. The Jurassic Park Jeep, at the very least. People can still do a runner out the back, but that's okay. Damn, chicken. Thanks. Oh, thanks for the donation, AFK. What's your content? OG Operation Genesis. It's a long time. What's your opinion on pineapple on pizza? I am very pro pineapple pizza. I'm sorry to tell you, doubters out there, but pineapple pizza is absolutely goated. This is not correct. Let me just... There we go. Oh, of course, because it's got everything up. I'm just going to try to get that to also fit in... I don't really care about that. I mean, it's not done, but it's nearly done. I didn't really want to spend all day on the truck, so... I'm moderately happy with it, I think. I'm trying to think about just, like, some decals on the side, or... Something we can add just to make it a little bit more military looking. How much does Spinosaurus weigh? At least 6 or 7. Check it out at night time. What's going on here? See, these are, I'm pretty sure these are... Where's that light coming from? Hello? I'm pretty sure these are off. What's going on there? Oh, right, okay, let me just... I think what we need is to fix that again. Mm-hmm, There's a light in here. There's a billion different little lights that I can't find. There's a yellow one in there somewhere. But I don't know where. It's not you. It's not you. It's not you. It's not you. Oh, wait. You cheeky little... Where the heck did... What are you two doing there? Get out. There we go. Because what I want to do is maybe use a spotlight instead. So it's actually projecting light out. It looks weird if it's just sort of glowing like that. What we want to do is take something like this. Jurassic Park 7 is not called Jurassic City. I don't know where people are getting this information, but it's full on not true. You know, I'm just going to remember what light is. I mean, the Jurassic City thing was temporary. It's an internal name only. And already the people are like, no, it's not called Jurassic City. It's called Jurassic Saga. Don't listen to anyone who tells you they know what the film is called. Nobody knows what the film is called. They're just wrong. It's going to go through a gajillion name changes before it comes out. Let me tell you that much. I've heard about 5 different names this week alone. This game has some real problems with, like, lighting. We do need to make these brighter, otherwise it's going to look stupid. Gonna make them white instead, though. Maybe see anything but white. Just I think looks a bit daft. Yeah. All right. Jurassic Saga is the current name. Favorite paleo documentary: Prehistoric Planet. Broccoli is horrific. have I considered producing? I mean, I've considered doing more educational content. That's been something on my list for a long time. At the end of the day, I'm not a paleontologist, and I don't have... You know, there's some fantastic paleo creators out there who obviously know a lot more than I do. So I don't want to... So anything I do has to be something that feels specific to me, you know? I don't want to just... There's no point in me just trying to do regular paleo content because... Well, why would anyone watch me do it as opposed to someone who actually knows what they're talking about? I did do a... Wait, also, how big are these? Wait. Let me. These might be too big. Let me grab my person. The tire... Okay, they're too big. They are absolutely too big. Oh, no, wait, okay, we need to... Oh, God, right, okay, let me just move that over there. Thank you. Because we need to duplicate these together, and I don't want to... Hello? Okay, whatever. Merge. My sensor scale was just whack. Whack-a-doodle. That's probably about right. Maybe even a little bit big still, but it's more justifiable, I think. I think that's okay, like that. See, I don't think I have actually seen Prehistoric Park, you know, funnily enough. Q freaking mongers. I just want one. Bam. Such destruction rewrought, you know? What on earth has happened here? Oh no. I can't really be sitting inside the earth though. How do I make that not look stupid? There's a trick to it, and I haven't figured it out yet. If I was a truck and I'd fallen over, I guess it would be more like just straight up, wouldn't it? Logically. Actually, it might even more like that, because the tires would... That looks weird. I don't know why. I'm trying to figure out why that I hate that with all the fibers of my being. Oh, right. That's what I was going to say. I did a thread on Twitter the other day. I tracked down... I'll tell you what. I can show you some of them. I think I've got them on my desktop still. Let me image. So I went and tracked down what I believe is the biggest collection of heraldry and flags in the world with dinosaurs on it. Like official flags and official heraldry that has actual legit dinosaurs on it. Non-avian dinosaurs, it's worth mentioning, because otherwise, you know, there's a billion. But I think I found 11 in total. It's cool stuff, actually. And then I had a couple of bonus ones, like this one from Russia that I really like. There's not many. 11 is the only amount I could find. The best is, of course, Granger, Washington, which looks like this. Where dinosaurs roam. Now, that is a Tuijangosaurus, a Psittacosaurus, and a... I can't remember what the sauropod is. But the funny thing is... Wait, you know, what is the sauropod? I really want to... I'm going to have to double check. A Apatosaurus. And the funny thing is, Psittacosaurus and Tuijangosaurus, neither of them are found, never mind in Granger, they're not found in the United States at all. They're literally Asian. And they're on this little US city. I think they thought this was a Stegosaurus. These are all ripped from like a paleo book from the 1980s, basically. And the reason they've got this, even though these dinosaurs weren't found in the city, is because the city has 32 life-size dinosaur statues spread all around the city. All right, so there you go. There's some of them. I'll show them all later. I do have a Brontosaurus one as well. All right, I'm going to say the trucks are done because I'm tired of messing with them, frankly. I think the important thing really is to try to get the... get some foliage and stuff into here. So, we've got cracks, right? It's a weird sentence. My. The problem is, I want this to be huge, but I don't want it to be thick. Shut up. I mean, I guess that's fine. If I... Because the idea is, I'm going to cover the thing in this, and then, well, it's not going to look quite like... Oh my god. Why? Oh, you're a corner, that's why. Ooh. If pretend it makes sense, alright? Don't argue with me. And this won't look like this. We're gonna this is where the foliage is gonna crop up, basically. The idea is that the foliage has begun to retake the area, essentially. I'm gonna do a couple more large ones and then we'll do some smaller ones. I'm hoping when we actually add the foliage it'll look less conspicuous. You're one of the statues. If I had a flag, I'm going to petition the Isle of Man, my home nation, to add dinosaurs to its flag. Never mind that we don't have dinosaurs in the Isle of Man. That's neither here nor there. Doesn't matter. We will add dinosaurs to the flag in honor of me. Just making this whole area feel destroyed in a realistic way that has foliage popping up. It's kind of the most important thing we're doing here, I think, in terms of bringing this build together. Because it's just, these walls are just too big and imposing on their own. There needs to be a reckoning. I might have gone overboard here. Eh. Okay, so we're gonna have some trees. I'm gonna grab some of these. Not too many trees. And we're going for skinny but tall. And mainly in the thicker cracks. Like, you know, where, like, this area here where there's lots of them joining together. So it feels more like there would be room for a tree to sprout up, essentially. A little bit in the wrong area as well. I'm going to have a couple of them in the middle. It's mainly going to be around the sides. Secret channel. Badly. Terribly. I mean, I don't really know how to put it. Terribly. But I'll get there. I have to get there. It's my future. I don't have a future for once. Oh. Let me just kill that. Yeah, secret channel. So... there's something I have to do. I have to fix the problem I caused, basically, that for my last idea that didn't bloody work. Once that's done, I can kind of progress with the next phase. This week I started that fixing process. I'm on my own now for like 10 whole days. So my plan across this next 10 days is to very much get that started. And hopefully, in a couple of weeks, I can get the next bit started. So, optimistically, I would suggest maybe a month. We shall see. I have to set up before I move out, though. So, if I was gonna go anywhere, I'd probably go to Hell Creek. You want to go to Hell Creek? I mean, look, I know it's like cliches. It's Triceratops and it's T-Rex. But, I mean, look, if you're going to go see dinosaurs, if you're going to see dinosaurs, non-avian dinosaurs, once, you want to see the big hitters, don't you? You don't want to screw around. I really think I need to have some destruction in a corner here. I'm kind of dabbling with the idea over here. I'm just thinking, how easy would it be to kill a wall and make it look not silly? Like, why would the whole wall... It just wouldn't, would it? It wouldn't collapse in like this. I guess we can pretend. Hey, you know what? That looks alright. That actually looks better than I expected. Let's do the same over here. Can't find the feeling, can't find the feeling inside. I'll just cover it in rocks and stuff, so it looks like there's, you know, there's been a rock fall or something. I will justify my destruction. And there's some cracks and stuff in there as well. Bam! Rock fall down. Yeah, I'd buy it. It looks alright. I'd buy that for $1. Same on this side. Again, we'll cover this in foliage and stuff like that. Just gotta establish a baseline. I have to sink you down a little bit, buddy. Come here, you little red lemon. We can, We probably need to break the fence occasionally, but that makes me a little nervous considering what we went through to build this fence in the first place. If I just rotate that, that's going to look stupid. The problem is the wire. I mean, the wire goes all the way down here, for God's sake. The fence is harder to break. I mean, it's not many games for many formations. Can you, I mean, is there a game for any formation other than Hell Creek? Thanks, Sarah B. Who's the Japanese man in the water, though? I mean, Prehistoric Planet, the thing is, I can see why they've stuck with late Cretaceous, because there's such a variety there, and obviously it made them get the second season out a lot quicker. I would like to see it change up, though. I mean, I'm down for more Cretaceous, I just don't want late Cretaceous. I think Triassic. Oh, I don't know. I don't think. Yeah, no. I mean, if it doesn't have to be dinosaurs, which I don't think it has to be, we can see the burgeoning of the dinosaurs. I think like Permian would be more interesting. We don't have much for that. Obviously, we've got Thingy on the way now, though. We've got some stuff coming. It's getting there. It's getting there. We're gonna throw in a lot more foliage. I just really want it to feel like it's falling apart. Trees behind here. You're never going to see behind here, so it doesn't matter what it actually looks like in reality. Reality's for nerds. As we know. Oh, yeah, so I was going to talk about, I want this to feel like it blends in, actually, so we need more trees. We need many more trees. Like, the tree should become sparse to the left, but not instantly. It should feel like it fades out, you know what I mean? So it's just dense jungle on this right-hand side. And then it gets sparser to the left, like that. That's what we're aiming for. Cute is what we're in for. Yada yada. Hit the ground. We're getting there, folks. We're getting there. I'm really worried about what I do after this bit, by the way. This is the easy bit. It's all like self-controlled and contained. It gets so much worse after this. Also, one thing I wanted to do, they've added a new path type. Stone Age substrate path, which... Can I replace path? Is that a thing? Yeah. So look, we can change it to substrate. Is that better? I don't know if it's better. It seemed like a very logical thing to do. It definitely feels more like a nature path. I don't know, think about that. Oh, I'm gonna run an advert. It's been an hour, so. Bear with me. I won't do anything. Take the opportunity to have a beverage. Le beverage. Where the rocks falling from? Look. We don't need questions like, where are the rocks falling from, okay? It doesn't matter. They fall. That's all you have to know, okay? They fall. Nothing else matters. Now, I'm going to bring some, let's put some rocks on the other side. Hopefully everyone's back right now. They should be. I don't know how long adverts last. If anyone even bloody sees them, frankly. I'm just going to put a little bit of rock on the other side. So it doesn't... See, I like that anyway. The things I do for you people, let me tell you. Justify my rock waffle. Nonsense. My favourite way to ever do rockfall in these games is actually to start with the bigger rocks like these ones that we just put down, and then you add the little bitty ones like this, and you kind of just stagger them along and let them fall into the gaps. And it looks like a rockfall. It's really, really effective. I do it on planets all the time. Are we happy? I do think that looks better, actually. Grumble, grumble. I will never admit it. I mean, I just did. But other than that, I'm never going to admit it. Just... I do like the rockfall, actually. I wasn't convinced, but I've been convinced, I'll say. It was always going to be tough to kind of figure out what was going to go beyond this wall. But we can use some rocks to kind of just block off that view a little bit as well. Because you're never going to see behind there. So we don't need to justify it. Alright, cool. It's getting there. Slowly but surely. We need a couple more things. We need a corpse pile, for example. What about a tree that's kind of been toppled a little bit? And is less weird. It's too straight on. Rocks do rock. I mean, we might throw some stuff in. People keep saying like, oh, wouldn't there be this, wouldn't there be that? We're not done yet, folks. When I say it's done, then you can be like, ah, you've missed out this. I'll be like, ah, you're completely correct. Let's get some foliage. So I just want this to be kind of sprouting up out of the ground. Here and there. Usually by a building or by rocks. Typically. I love hiding foliage behind like a little bit of rock. It's basically my favourite thing to do in all of human history. Second favourite thing. Hey, good. You know, maybe the truck's overgrown, especially because it's toppled over. And as we all know, plants love toppled over rocks, trucks. And that tree is floating, which is cool. If you're into that, personally. Whew. Okay, you stop that. Save me, save me. It's me when I'm gone. My concern is still, how do I keep the coelophysis contained, by the way? I need to... Well, we'll figure that out later. It's fine. It's fine. It's a feature me problem. Feature me's a nerd. Can it be trusted? Where's my other bush? That's my other bush. My arrowhead. Same idea with the rockfall, that we have some foliage that kind of feels like it's sort of clambering over the fences, essentially. It's like creeping further and further in over time. Like so. I actually really like that. I was just doing an experiment there, like how long I could not talk for without feeling awkward. I tell you what, I lasted about 5 seconds. Shut up. Not hearing a word on that one, Jesus. It's instant. I used to, I got a big problem where I need to slow down. I talk too fast. And it's like when I record for videos, you know, when I do like a scripted video, I actively think about, am I talking too fast? Because I just do. And I remember getting called out on it at university. I was really excited about like presenting my essay. I was thinking, well, I've got more talking experience than basically everyone on the planet because I do it constantly all day. And my lecturer pulls me aside and said, yeah, the content was good, but you just talk far too fast. And I'm like, yeah, okay. I'm ashamed. And one of my big regrets in life is not sticking with that law degree. I can't say that much. I really like how this looks. To the point where I should probably stop doing it because I feel like I'm going to get addicted to it. It's like there's going to be too much of it if I keep going. But it's really helping with that. This is looking so much better. I just knew I just had to stick with it. And if you stick with things, they look cool eventually. That's the deal. This is Sandbox. It really does look monumentally better. Yeah, right. Yeah. The problem is when it starts to impede on your real life. I wonder if I could go back to do lore. Actually, I might be able to go back to do lore. That's an interesting idea. Can I remember? Really? The good thing about this bush is you can kind of... You don't need to angle it at all. You kind of just stick it in there. That's what we all want to do. And it kind of just... It naturally looks... It's a creepy bush. You know what I mean? It's a creeper. It naturally has creepy tendencies. Here as well. Again, just kind of trying to sell the idea that nature is this kind of like encroaching around the sides of the facility, and it's just, I wish I hadn't picked the same wall on both sides to break. Now that I look at it, that's quite a big mistake. But you know, it's like the facility was barely containing the nature beyond it, and now that the facility has been abandoned, nature's just pouring inside. You know, that's the idea. What's a matrix speech? I think the problem... The only problem I have with that is that Bigfoot doesn't exist. Like, I think it's really hard to justify the existence of Bigfoot. And it's getting harder and harder. Because why would there not be footage at this point? There just would be. You just can't have this gigantic ape wandering around and not have footage. And people will say, oh, well, we find new species all the time. Which is true. And we do find bigger species. Sometimes we find new primates and stuff like that. But we find them in the middle of the Amazon rainforest or something like that. We don't find gigantic 7-foot hominids wandering around the Pacific Northwest in heavily populated areas. You know what I mean? Like, I'm a big fan of Bigfoot and cryptids. I've seen about 7 Bigfoot films this year, unironically. But I don't think there's any justification for him to be actually real. We live in an era where everyone's got a really good phone, and yet all cryptid footage is terrible quality. And it isn't a coincidence. Grifters is what they are. I just can't justify it. I wish it was real. From the bottom of my heart. But I have not seen any compelling evidence. At all. Okay, I'm really happy with how this is turning out. This is very sexy. I'm very talented. We need more foliage in the middle. But it does feel nature's taken over, which is very much the idea. Bigfoot, yeah, Megalodon's even worse, man. Like, there's this 50-foot shark out there that we somehow haven't noticed. No. How? There's never any justification for it. No one's ever got any ideas how it would happen. Nonsense, man, nonsense. It's a fun thing to believe. Like ghosts. I love ghost stories. When I was younger, I didn't believe in ghosts, but I used to go ghost hunting. My mum ran a bloody ghost hunting thing. It was a job. She did ghost hunts. I don't believe in them. It's just fun, you know? And the thing is, that my conspiracy theory that I do believe is that the government is very happy. You know Area 51, for example, if you believe there's aliens at Area 51. The government's very happy for you to believe. And I would suggest probably promotes the idea that there are aliens at Area 51. Area 51? 55? What did I just say? Anyways. Because it means you're not paying attention to what they actually do. You know what I mean? It's like, oh, they've got aliens there, blah, blah, blah. No. Not that I don't believe in aliens. If you're going to believe in anything, believe in aliens. But, the government is all too happy for you to spend time believing this kind of nonsense. Instead of paying attention. Anyway, that's my own. That's basically the only conspiracy theory that I believe in. That the government probably promotes that kind of thing in some ways because, they'd rather you pay attention to that kind of detail rather than what they're doing. My mum does sound like someone you would get on with, yes. I always felt that. What am I doing with my life? Why are you blue today? Don't necessarily... I'm trying to establish a time frame. How long has this been overgrown? Because that will determine what kind of plants we have. It really is looking so much better. I can see Coelophysis hanging around here having a lovely time. It's still on the way, Slavic. It's on the way. It's very slowly. Things keep going wrong, but it's fine. I'll get there. Thanks, Yoshua. I need to watch the video again. You're not allowed to talk to me until I watch the video again, okay? A little bit of foliage creeping through. If we make this really small, actually, and just kind of have that. Actually, what I want to do, squeeze it in. Just kind of have that. Coming through some of the cracks. Cool. Yosh. Yosh, like that. Yosh. It's a soft J, right? But yeah, sorry, Slavic. I already answered it earlier. And I'm frustrated with the project, so I get frustrated talking about it. It is going to happen. It is. I spent so much money on it, for God's sake. I'm hoping about a month, if I had to guess. But that's why I haven't been talking about it. It's just because there's still plenty to do, you know? We'll throw some other plants in here as well. I'm really happy how that truck turned out, considering how we made it. I am also my favourite YouTuber. I also saw ghosts as a child, but I was a child, so I don't really count it for anything. Like, I don't care what people want to believe in. If people want to believe in ghosts, that's totally cool. People should absolutely feel fine to believe in what they want to believe in. But I think that means I can also believe it's stupid, you know? It kind of goes both ways. Not stupid, not that the belief is stupid. Wait, this is hard to justify now. I know what I mean. That's what matters. I don't know. I became more cynical with age. I just all these things that we think exist, and yet in an age where everyone's got a goddamn camera, we have no decent evidence. It just doesn't make any sense to me. And logically, I don't see how a ghost could possibly exist. You know, logically, scientifically, it doesn't make any sense to me. And that's enough for me to be like, well, you know. But hey, that's what it is. Everyone's got their thing. I'm sure I believe something. I mean, I believe aliens exist. I don't necessarily believe that they've come to Earth. But I do believe extraterrestrial life. What was it that I was watching? Something about aliens. Oh, I watched Melancholia by Lars von Trier the other day. And there's a whole thing about how this woman who's suffering from depression. The whole film's basically a metaphor for depression. It's a horrible film, but brilliant film. Deeply loved it. And the world's ending. It's a disaster film, essentially. There's another planet that's about to collide with Earth. And it's going to happen. Like, it's established at the start of the film. This is happening. Everyone's going to die. And the discussion on extraterrestrial life comes up, and the character, who's played by Kirsten Dunst, is just like, no, there's nothing out there. This is it. Once this happens, all life in the world is over. It's great. Yeah, I mean, if I was a ghost, I'd be like, I'd be fucking shit off. I'd be having a great time. But no, I'm going to spend my afterlife opening cupboards. What? Why? Get a life, ghost. And then there's always a justification like, oh, you know, they don't appear to you unless you believe. Like, that, what's the scientific justification for that? How does that make sense? But like I say, totally fine if you want to. I always feel like I'm judging, and I'm really not trying to. It's just I don't believe. And, you know, if that's you know, viable as well. And that's despite my mum being a crazy ghost person. Although less so these days. She's calmed down a little bit, I would suggest. She is Wiccan. My sister's Wiccan. It's funny in my family. The men are, like, hyper-scientific and the women are completely the opposite. And it's very, very noticeable. I mean, my granddad was an astrophysicist, for God's sake. Okay, I think I'm nearly happy. I want something in this middle bit, and it's annoying me that I don't have anything in the middle bit. I hate middle bits. Middle bits are the worst bits. Everyone knows that. I guess it's okay. We'll have coelophysis wandering around. No, I can't block the gate straight up, because this is how people walk in, right? That's kind of the issue. I need the dinosaurs to stay in here. But you need to be able to walk in as well. That's the issue. Oh, it's a track. So yeah, well, my mum hates my dad, so I'm not sure about that. I mean, my mum used to tell me a story that I used to come running screaming at night because there's like a man standing at the foot of my bed. Now, she tells me it's because it's a ghost. I suspect we had a home invader. And there was just a man standing at the foot of my bed. But, it's never here, not there. What time are you streaming till? Not a Dickens. Usually in for 3 hours, but as I explained a little bit at the start, I am incredibly tired. Well, I'm actually fairly wide awake right now, but I shouldn't be wide awake. I haven't slept really, so I'm theoretically tired. hasn't quite come to fruition quite yet, but I am theoretically tired. Okay, I'm really happy about it. I was. I'm not gonna lie. I was a bit apprehensive about this because I just thought I don't think it's gonna work. I don't think we're gonna be able to make this look how I got it in my head, but it's kind of happened. I'm immensely talented, it's crazy. Right, so we need to build some things. I'm gonna move you, because you're kind of in the way. This is the thing, ghosts is probably like the most common belief, compared to like cryptids and stuff like that. Ghosts, for me, are like one of the most unlikely, because I just can't justify it. Like, I don't see how it would make any sense. What are they? Why is that? Like, what do you mean by energy? Nobody, it never means anything. Whereas a cryptid, Yeah, okay, I might not believe in... I love cryptids, but I don't believe in any of them, basically. But the chances of, like, an undiscovered animal being out there are much more likely. That's a tangible, real thing. You know what I mean? That's a possibility, at least in my head. That would make sense in a logical world. Not necessarily the way most cryptids are described. You know, I don't think there's a ropan out there, a flying pterosaur with a glowing red belly. But at least, you know, an undiscovered hominid or something like that, as unlikely as it is at least a tangible, real thing. I can justify that in my head. I can't justify ghosts. But again, doesn't matter if I don't. Oh, be awfully boring if we all had the same beliefs. Just hate those corners, so to cover them up a little bit. See you, Fab. Oh yeah, how are we going to get in the park? I've just realised. How do we get inside? Huh. Maybe we don't. Maybe I don't need to worry about... Huh. Oh no. We're going to have to put a gap in the wall. Right? We'll have to put a gap in the wall somehow. First, how do you get in? Yeah... I mean, people talk about cryptids like the chupacabra. The chupacabra is my favourite example because I know people who believe in the chupacabra. I've seen several films about the chupacabra. It's really took off in popular culture. The chupacabra was invented in 1995, for the love of God. I am older than the chupacabra, unironically. And, like, when you look at the history of it, yeah, okay, there were goat mutilations and stuff like that. Let's figure out what that's about. But the chupacabra aspect of it, the woman who first saw it in Puerto Rico described it... Now it's like this weird dog thing, but when the chupacabra was originally described, it was this short, large-headed, basically an alien. This spiky, large-headed, short, large-eyed, alien grey creature thing. And as it happens, this woman had been to the cinema that week and she'd seen the film Species. And Species happens to contain an alien that looks exactly like what she described. There's going to be a gap in the wall. It makes sense anyway for there to be a crack in the wall. I'll figure out how it's going to work. Oh yeah, we can have to get... the problem is, I have to fix it, because look, it's solid from behind. My plan originally, I was just going to duplicate all this, flip it around. We could do a tunnel. I think something. Do you believe in soul? Do you believe that when we die, we're gone forever? No, I believe when you're dead, you are dead. You are done and you are gone forever. And to me, people say that's depressing. I think that's not. I think that's good. I think that's comforting in a way. You get one chance at life to live the best life you possibly can. There's no do-overs. There's no need to worry about heaven or hell or any of that nonsense. It's get this one life and just live it how you want to live it. And then, you know, your time's done. And that's fine, right? You deserve a little peace at the end, surely. Right. So I think I need to stop pointing off the building aspects, because I've done all the foliage. I'm really happy with how it turned out, but... there's a couple things I still need to build. I think what I'll probably end up doing, I'm going to do what I said, but what we'll do is we'll change this block here, and I'll just make this doorway ajar, and you'll just walk through this little gap here. Through there, basically. Or we could do the same, but knock this over. It's going to be one of those two. Not sure yet. None of it. It just doesn't make sense. Whoa, Nicholas. Whoa. I mean, that's kind of a compliment. I think you need to say something. Wait, no. You kind of negged me and threw the compliment in. I don't care what people believe in. It doesn't bother me. If you want to believe in an afterlife, if you want to believe in God, if you want to believe in any of it, that's totally okay. that's cool. I'm sure it brings comfort to people. It just wouldn't bring comfort to me, that's all. Anywho, what's I doing with my life? Oh yeah, so what I wanted... Oh, we should do it over here. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna do this now because it's gonna annoy me otherwise. Blah, blah, blah. It's gonna annoy me anyway, but that's fine. I think it annoys me. I'm gonna grab it. Are you separate? Why are you separate? Oh, because you hate me, that's why. Oh, actually, that's actually immense. Okay, Wait, bear with me. For some reason, these blocks... Okay, is that the whole thing? Hopefully. Nope. God, everything's just attached to, like, super weird things. I don't know what I've done. I do this every time. Let me merge all that together as well. No, not you. God damn it. Okay, sweet. That's what I wanted. That's what I want. That on its own. Okay, let's see what we can do here. So... Let's move you out of the way. And then what we need to do... Bring these bits in. So that they make a bit of a tunnel. Yeah, that's fine, actually. A little bit of a gap. Do the same on the other side. Make sure that's even. It is nowhere near symmetrical. My God. You know what? If I just don't point it out, nobody will notice. It's okay. It's okay. It's still good. It's still good. It's gone, Dad. Thank you, Sexo. Dino Park Tycoon. Suspect not, if I'm honest. It sounds ancient. Okay. Taking control of our lives. There we go. See? Easy peasy. Tunnel. Bam. Humans. I don't know if they can actually walk through that. I suspect they probably can't. And then, oh no, the door fell over. Oh no. What is a boy to do? So that's how you get in the park. Okay. And now what we need to do is grab all of these. Nope, wait, the first thing we need to do. Ah, that's good, that's fine. Grab all of these. And duplicate. There we go. And then it's the same on both sides. Oh, wait. Oh. That's fine. It's fine. We'll fix it. We'll fix it. I just need to delete that one and duplicate that one. And then delete this one. Okay, one sec. I need to delete that one. Move that one across. There's such a big gap on there. And then do that over there. No, no, the door fell over. Is the cap that big on... Oh, I haven't got the, this stuff. Same glue, for some reason. I was always there, but you just... Boop-a-da-bum. Okay. And that should get you into the park. I don't want to do anything on the walls. I think it's fine. It works. All right, that's all that matters. It bloody worked. Again, what we do beyond this is terrifying. I really don't want to think about that kind of stuff. You know, I haven't played Lethal Company yet. I keep hearing really good things about it, though. It's just a regular old dinosaur park. Totally normal dinosaur park. Right, there's a few things I want to build. So, do I like this? It looks very outdated. Let me have a little think. I want to build like a spotlight. Let me just try to find a better picture. I want like a military grade spotlight. That's going to sit up here. I want like a modern one. This one looks like it's from the 50s. Yeah, this one looks good. Let's go for this. Alright. Let's build some spotlights. Okay, if I was a spotlight, how big would it be? A question we must all ask ourselves. At the end of the day. And also texture-wise, what do I want to do here? Is anyone round? Who wants to be round? I do. I need to make a cylinder, basically. Okay, if I... I know this looks weird right now, just bear with me. Meh. Meh. We will change the texture. There we go, we made a cylinder. Now, whether we need to do this or we need a... It's not that long, is it? Probably about there. Let's see what we can do. If we can find one that's going to match. Oh, the glass one is very cool, actually. I'm not sure what for, but I like it. Oh my god. Why did you change size so much? Wait, what's going on? I mean, the texture isn't designed for this. No, that one's okay, though. That one's not bad. We could roll with that. Just... It's maybe a little shiny. That's winning so far, but let's see what else we've got. I mean, none of the others are going to make any sense, are they? You know what? I don't hate that texture. Well, I'd like it more if I could change the colour. I can't seem to change. Oh my god. What I'm doing here. There's one I didn't hate, that one. I'll say it's too big. Yeah, that's alright, actually. It's kind of perfect, weirdly enough. So if I was a spotlight, how big would I be? It has to be controlled by a human, but it's meant to be big. So that's probably too big, right? You'd have like a thing on the back, like a... It's probably a little bit too big. Not too much, though. It's meant to be intimidating in size. Something like that. My little dude's about to get crushed. I just noticed his head is slightly wonky. Slightly off to the side. Yeah, some more rusted metal would be great. Mud puddles. I've done some stuff like that already of these little things. I don't know what else I would put a bit more of this in, but it's hard to build something that looks like mud. You know what I mean? You know what I mean. Everyone knows what I mean when I say mud. Alright, that is perfect. I'm just going to steal you, if you don't mind, my friend. Don't steal me. Oh, no, maybe not. Stole the wrong thing. Eh? There we go. Don't steal me. Are you on your own? No. There we go. It's got a little grate on it, which is kind of perfect. My example image also has a little grate on it. We love a little grate. We live for the little grate. Why is it black, though? Do I need to make this nighttime to make it pop up? Yep. What is... what's going on? Why is it going bonkers? Game. They really need to do something about the shadows in this game. The tree shadows go absolutely wild. Why is this not on? I don't understand. Are you not a light? I thought you were a light. You're a light on the car. Why are you not a light over here? Can anyone explain this to me? Oh, there we go. That was weird. So I think I want to... Yeah, that's fine. And then we need to grab a thingamajiggy. You know what I mean? You know what I mean. It's fine. Where's my thingamajiggy? The problem is this light... I mean, it looks kind of huge. But as you see, if I scale that up, I don't believe it changes the actual size of the light. I think we had this conversation the other day. But in you pop. Yourself. Okay, there we go. Yeah, that'll do. Right, let's make it daytime so I don't have to look at this bloody flickering shadow anymore. It's making me very sad. Okay, good start. Oh, I'm sorry, Sarah. Feel better. Good to know how big you would be if you were a spotlight. I appreciate that. I think this is actually a little bit too big. Oh, god damn it. Oh, there we go. I think I'm more like that. Okay, and then what we need to try to do... I want to put a little bit of a rim on it. Do I want a little rim? Maybe I don't want a little rim on it. I do want to stop saying rim. There isn't one on the one I'm looking at, so I think it's fine like that. So we need to get some details. Things. It needs like a plinth. Everyone loves a plinth. So I made this out of You're my plinth, baby. As everyone knows, this is the most important part of building a dinosaur park. So that's what it's going to sit on. It's made me realise that this is much too tall, much too high. More like that. Bloody hell. Right, and then I need to... I need to build like a thing. You know what I mean? I need to build a thing. I'm going to build a thing. It's what I'm most known for. Angle snap. We're going to go 45, hopefully. Does that not change? Oh, there we go. Come on. Come on. No. Eh? Eh. I don't know. Okay, I did it. I don't really know how. It's not... depressing as it sounds. That can be that. That's fine. And that's going to kind of stick. That's too big, obviously. Like that. It's our supporting structure. Hold it in place. And let's grab that, rotate that around, have one on the other side. Lovely, lovely. Ooh. Oh no. I hate rotating anything over the 90 degrees. I think we've all been there. I think the plinth is too big. We've all been there as well. First of all, why are you not even? Why have you shifted? Oh, for God's sake. Okay, why have we got two of them? Maybe I had questions. You go there. It looks like it's doing like a little weird squat. Let me think about this. If I lower these down... Okay, what are you doing? I just want to grab this, man. I'm really struggling to grab this bit of metal. There we go, bloody Nora. It's really, really difficult to grab. If I grab that and grab that, and then we sink this down. Make sure that's even in the middle. And then we can raise these back up. That should solve our problem. And that should match with that, because that's cool. Bam! Spotlight. We're not done yet, but we're getting there. Thanks, Matthew. It's fine. It's fine. Certain people are determined to make me feel as old as humanly possible, anyway. You get used to it. I want, like, some little... This one's got, like, valves on it for some reason. Little things. I like little things. I do want more detail on it, but I kind of want it all to be the same colour, which means I have to keep using the construction kit. If I use the roof, actually... Is that cool? I don't know. It might be. I don't know what I want to use it for, but I do like how it looks. What if we put this on the back? Just because why not? Basically, I think that's enough reason to do anything. Like when you ask the people who climb Everest, right? Why did you climb Everest? And they said, because it's there. I watched, Oh, right, I keep meaning to talk about this. I watched Poor Things the other day, finally. It's like my most anticipated film for ages. And if you haven't seen it, it's really good, so you should go watch it. Okay? Stop watching me right now and go watch Poor Things. It's my favourite film of the year so far. Although I am expecting Dune 2 to supplant it when I go see it in a couple of weeks. Okay. I like that. I don't know to what end it exists, but I like it. I'm going to use it as like a little bit of a river as well. Just make these bits a little bit more interesting at the side. These little arms. It needs to look sturdy and military, you know. It's their official terms. Actually, well, sturdy is, but military, as they say in the clubs. Of course, you've shifted needlessly out of position. Just get in the position I put you in and stay there, alright? I mean, I don't hate this as it is. I'm gonna bring this in a little bit, I think. I'd prefer it. It's just this weird little hunched over thing. I'm gonna make this look a little bit better down here. I think this is kind of the main problem area. You want me to... So it looks more like a stand rather than a block. Okay, pretty happy with that. Yeah. I want to do like a bit of a handle on the back. The idea being this is what you would grip onto, right? This is what you would hold onto and you would angle the spotlight using this. My overcompensation with your own ambivalence. That's a bit too high up, isn't it? You'd have to be a goddamn giant to operate this thing. Which I think is going to remain true no matter where I put this, but we can make it a little bit more realistic. Excuse me? Why can't I? Oh, there we go. That was weird. Oh, no. Yeah, there we go. Put that down there. For the humans.
Went up there to live, exactly. I used to really like Everest. I remember I saw it on the first date. Second date. And I really got into the film. And then the more I've watched it,
the more I've come to dislike it. I'm not really sure why. I don't think it needs more than that. I think it's okay. I think I'm in danger of putting too much on it. It doesn't sound like me, I know, but I'm gonna stick a random trapezoid on it. But other than the random trapezoid, nothing else is going on this, okay? Needs like a little bit of detail on the top here, so it looks a little bit more interesting. Military shapes, as they're known, probably. It's like a shark fin, which is cool. Same on the other side, and then I think we will call this one a day. Well, not the entire thing, just the spotlight, just to allay any fears. Time's up, nearly 9, okay. Alright, cool. The question actually is, well, first of all, the question is, how do I make sure I've got everything selected? Yeah, lovely. Right, we're going to grab this and let me just go stop pressing every single incorrect button. First of all, I'm going to add this to my workshop just so I've got this available later on. Prefab, that's how. spotlight. Because round like spot and is light. Safe. Hi. Thanks, Al. It's very nice of you. Wound up here. I think I want these. I don't know where I want this to be. First thing I need to do is turn off. I'm gonna snap. My initial thought was to have it up here. Wait, what are you doing? What's going on? Pair with me. No, that's why. Kind of like sitting up here on the thing. so that when you round the corner, we need to go check it out at nighttime, because really these are here for nighttime. I'm a little worried they're too small, actually, weirdly enough. I'm gonna scale them up a little bit. They're meant to be intimidating in size, you know? And I'm gonna rotate them forward a little bit. I don't care if it doesn't make sense. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of what I wanted. Let me just make it nighttime. I wanted to kind of like blast you in the face as you round the corner. Which it doesn't really do, if we're totally honest. This is a problem, like I said, the lights inside, the actual spotlight effect, just doesn't scale with size at all. So, it's always small. Kind of just looks like it's got a weird face. I think if I put more of these in... is that too much? What do we think? I'm not sure. I mean, what we'll probably do is turn some of them off, so I'll just suggest breakage. I might spread them out a little bit more. I might only do maybe four of them or something like that. Well, I'd have to do an odd number. It's meant to feel like a quarantine zone. It's kind of like the city has been quarantined and you're not allowed inside, you know? So they're kind of like... flashing the lights at everyone on the outside, keeping them away, making sure they can see what's going on, blah, 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 blah. I just need to kill the lights on this sheep. Oopsie daisy. There's always one. There's always one. Swear to God, there's always one. How I ended up around here. I think I'm happy with it. I might bring one or two of them down here as well. Let's turn some of them off. I'll have some of them a bit dimmer. I think these middle two should be the two that are definitely on. Full power. And then we'll dim this one a little bit as well. I'm going to turn that one off. Yeah, I think I'm happy with that now. I'm gonna bring a couple of them down. Let me just grab one. And then I can use that as an excuse to light things. What are you doing, you cheeky little? Come here. Do what I command. And your subby little spotlight. Swap to that. I could have this kind of maybe sitting at the military side and facing the I was going to build a guard tower, so maybe we could stick it on there. I'm going to put it down here for now. I'm not sure about this, though. The idea is that it would be shining on. I kind of like trying to create a split here between the military and the CHC. Let me just put some rocks around it. I'm gonna ruin it a little bit and that'll help. Just break things a little bit, that makes everything better. Bam. Sorted. Oh, I need to stretch my legs. 1 sec. Ah. This is why I need a studio. There's no room, man. There's no room. Oh, god damn. Woo. I'm too tall for this. I need to be a small person. Give me a minute. My kneecaps don't work. Oh, god. I broke my knee. Well, I dislocated my knee about 7 years ago. I swear it just hasn't recovered at any point. Oh. Okay, we're back. Right. Do I want to do the pile of burning bodies? Is the question. Or is that a little bit too much? The idea, I mean, it wouldn't actually be a pile of burning bodies. It would be pile of burning bodies adjacent. Where's the campfire thing? Well, I quite like this actually. Interesting. Yeah, I'm gonna make it this year. I swear to God, it's really annoying me that things keep getting in the way. But hopefully this is the year. I'm going to be closer to London this year. I'm quite far away at the moment. This has caused problems, but I should be a lot closer. Oh, we could put some mushrooms in. These are new, actually. Oh, we're going to have to go back into the forest and stick some mushrooms in. Because these are new. I've not had a chance to mess around with these yet. It's from the latest update. I saw Darren was talking about it on Twitter, saying that it's based on whether the book comes out or not, but that this year's TetsuCon was going to be cryptid based. I was like, yeah, I'm not missing that one. That's hype. That's great. Oh, I don't think I've seen this one. That must be. Oh, it's cute. Yeah. How goes the workout? Funnily enough, I'm actually having a week off. But yeah, actually, other than the fact that I'm currently having a week off, it's been going really well. I'm taking a week off because I've had... So a few weeks... I mentioned it probably in the last stream. I did some damage to my right shoulder. Well, actually, to both shoulders, I should say. Both shoulders just fell apart. Oh, I forgot there's moss as well. Oh, clumpy moss. I did some damage to my shoulders. And I've got a recurring problem on my... Oh no, the moss. Oh no. I've got a recurring problem with the lower left on my back as well. It's just been going on and on. Because, you know, I'm lifting fairly heavy weights, so I injure myself. It's part and parcel. It's what I expect. It's not an issue. But it just hasn't been healing, and my shoulders in particular just haven't been healing at all. There's been no recovery. And every time I do a bicep curl or anything like that, the front of both my shoulders is just on absolute fire. To the point that I can't lift my arms for about half an hour afterwards, and it's agonizing. It's not like, oh, muscle weakness. It's active, painful pain. So I'm taking a week off, which makes me sad. But hopefully, when I get back on Sunday for pull day, I will be relatively healed. And I can get back to it. Is the idea. Didn't really think about what I'm doing here. I just kind of started doing it. there was no thought involved. It was just, oh, I like it. Let's just throw it in there. I mean, it's really good to make things feel overgrown. At the end of it, it's moss. I really like it, actually. This is going to be problematic. But yeah, so week off. First week off other than ages, anyway. And then back to it on Sunday, hopefully. Oh no, back to it on Sunday. I might just have a slightly easier week to try and ease back into it. Yeah, they're great, aren't they? It's, you know, the thing that makes these work really well is the grass, well, moss, whatever. I don't know if it's grass or sprouting moss. But the fact that it's got this kind of like raised furry texture looks really good. And I'm a little worried I'm going to go overboard on it, but I think it's really, really good looking. And it's selling that overgrown vibe really nicely. That one was too far, I decided. Yeah, nice. Yeah. I don't really know what it is. Like, I don't know what I've done to my shoulders. I just went in, I was doing hammer curls, and I think it was about the 8th rep, and both shoulders went instantly, so I clearly did something wrong in my... I just wasn't paying attention, my technique was bad. Also, again, it's the 8, it's always the 8, and both shoulders just instantly went, and it just hasn't recovered. Yeah, I'm wondering... because the idea was to have it in this corner, right? Move this tree out of the way. And add another crack to justify the tree. I was going to have a pile of bodies in the corner. God, I love that. I need to go back into my forest and add the moss everywhere. Because it's amazing. It's my favourite new item. Which is unexpected. It's really good. And it's so perfect for the build. I'll do that later. What we can do as well, we can add some of this to... that might be... maybe. Like that, kind of? Something like that? Yeah, I think that looks alright, actually. Because we're going to need to do some damage to the walls. Thanks, Al. Shacks. Yeah, we just integrated that earlier. Just blends in, really. It just looks like a full... I've been asking for, like, a natural path for this game. Just last stream, I was saying I need, like, a natural path. And lo and behold, here we go. This looks like a natural trail. And I really like it emphasizes the contrast between the two areas so much more. Yeah, I'll know by Sunday if I've recovered. I'm looking forward to getting back in training. I don't like missing training. I was slacking for a while. I've been slacking. And I've just finally got back into it properly, you know, consistent. I'm in there 6 days a week at the moment. And then I have to take a bloody break. Feel like... Yeah, okay, it's fine. Oh, like a metal... an open front metal box, basically, yeah? Let me see if I can find what you mean. Right, I'm going to Google it. I'm going to throw out an advert while I do this. Enjoy. I'm trying to find an example. I just need like an... metal. Kind of works. When you say shack to me means like housing. Do you mean housing, or are we talking about like a container unit, or? Because I'm thinking just like basically a metal box with the front open that you'd have like some crates and stuff in. Or maybe like a three-sided or four-sided metal box, basically. And you know what? I'll start building it, and we'll go from there. Did I not get a reference for this? No, I didn't. You should start again. Come back home to me. It's always nearly Coelophysis time. It's never Coelophysis time, but it's always nearly Coelophysis time. The Coelophysis are going in today, I promise you that much. They are. What the heck? Why? Wait, what? Why? Let me just do that. That was weird. Oh, no, I see why. I see why. It's fine. It's fine. Is this kind of what you mean? I've got, like, an image in my head of the decoration in Evolution 2, but I don't know if it's the one you were referring to. Yeah, we'll do some crates and we'll make some boxes in a second as well. I mean, that's basically what the decoration looks like to me. I can't... Maybe I have like a supporting structure in the middle. Put in the shadow of the tree. That'll look cool. The shadow of the Erd tree. Very excited about that. My favorite thing in all of history is in all of time and space and history is hiding parts of plants behind buildings and behind rocks. Nothing ever looks as good.
You sent a link. Where did you send a link?
Did I miss it? The developers of Ori have a new game coming out. No Rest for the Wicked. Nice. No, I haven't seen Hasbin Hotel. It doesn't really look like my kind of thing, if I'm honest. I don't really have anything to... Oh, did I miss this? I don't think I saw the link. Wait, is this last week? Or now? Because I don't see anything today. Oh, let me check my history. Jane Vice? No, that's not it. February 22nd. No. I mean, we need a little bit more of that. I think the only thing I want to build now... I'm pretty happy with this, I've got to say. Like I said, we might do a little bit more detail. Didn't I download some prefabs last week for this specific purpose? School bus? No. Probably I didn't. Volcano? Why have I got a volcano? I mean, it's cool, don't get me wrong. Livonian Sea Live, fantastic one. Got this ages ago. I won't use them though. I mean, I'm not going to say Arthur Lawrence every time. Oh, but not Al. I get you. Right, I see what you mean now. So, Arthur. Right, yeah, no worries. Arthur. Maybe I should make a little box. I'm going to make a little box. I don't want to make a little box. I'm going to make a little box. Bam, box. Kind of unironically, box. Is there any, like, just straight up wood, though? Modern. Yeah, alright. Box, there we go. I mean, I wanna change the color up a little bit, though. Not like that. Easy peasy. Stack a couple of these in the corner. everything. Another one kind of tumbling over. In a way that maybe makes sense. Maybe. There's no football on tonight, really annoyingly. I should really go to sleep, actually. I shouldn't be worrying about it, but I'm in the mood for some football, but there's just nothing on. The MLS has thankfully started again, so at least there's regular MLS football on the weekends. That looks weird. Why does that look so weird? I'm not going to save a prefab for the box, but I kind of wish I had a prefab for the box. No. Okay. You do what you want to do, buddy. I'm not here to judge. Oh, God. I am more and more thinking I really, really need to see a doctor about my sleep. Like, everyone says that they're insomniac and everyone's got their problems and yada, 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 which is true. Lots of people struggle with their sleep. I'm not going to pretend otherwise. But it's been a problem for me, and a big problem for a long, long time now. It's like not... It's a really, really long time. The other day, I decided to stay up. So this was Tuesday, I think. I decided I was going to stay up overnight. My sleep was a bit of a disaster, so I thought, right, I'm going to stay up overnight. I'm going to fix my sleep. No, wait, what day did the gas people get? No, this was last week, so this was last Friday. I stayed up overnight. We had obviously had a gas leak last week, which is why we didn't stream last week. And I thought, okay, what I'll do is I'll stay up overnight, because the gas people are coming in the morning anyway, so I need to be awake when they get here. So I've been awake for about 24, 25 hours or something like that. And the gas people are still here, but I ended up falling asleep on my desk. I ended up having like a little nap. So I napped for about an hour. Literally a single hour. And then the gas guy knocked on the door and I had to go, you know, sort that out. And then, so I slept for an hour in a 24 hour span. And then I didn't sleep again the next day until 8 a.m. or something like that. So in the span of, I think it was about 45 hours, I've been awake for about, I slept for about an hour. And I'm just awake. My body just doesn't want to sleep. It hates me. It's ridiculous. I'm getting to the point where I need to give up on this whole... What the hell just happened? Where's my lovely plant gone? I need to give up on this whole, oh, I'm gonna stay up overnight and reset my sleep. It doesn't matter. It doesn't do anything to me. It doesn't make a difference, for God's sake. So I need to move out and live on my own again, so I don't need to worry about it as much. I can train at 3 in the morning if I want to. Yeah, if you don't mind, Jordan. Just so I can make this a bit more interesting. I mean, I just want to throw some details on it. That'd be good. I mean, I don't have the art station. If the art station is it, I don't have the link anymore. You just throw me the link. That'd be easier. Once that's going on, the last thing I want to build... Because this area is a little bit... This is our... Oh, you know what we need to do? I'm just going to build like a little bench. Like a little bed bench. Maybe, Arthur, maybe. I was a little bit... Oh, we got fabric. Fair... What's it called, though? What's it called? What are you called? What's your name? I can't tell. The game doesn't tell me. Oh, yeah. Make it a... Oh, that's an interesting idea. Yeah, I'll throw some stuff in there. Yeah, no. It's a... My sleep has been disastrous for a very, very, very long time. It's a problem. And I don't really mind if I'm living alone, but if I've got a partner, if I'm staying with people or whatever, if I'm trying to go to a family event, it's a disaster. Like, I'm fine having totally destroyed sleep and living like that, because my job allows for that, you know? And I like being up at 4, 5, 6, 7 in the morning and blah, blah. That's fine for me. I'm a night owl anyway, but it's getting ridiculous. It really is. I'm gonna see a doctor about it. What are these called? The game really needs to tell you what something is called when you click on it. What are you? I don't remember. Doesn't it if I do this? No, what's your name? What are you? I genuinely don't know. Is it in props? No. Structural elements, if I had to guess. I just want to build like a little hammocky beddy kind of thing. No. What are these again? Oh, Stone Age, cave prints. Not for now. Scenery? No. No. Guys, what's it called? Tarp. Tarp? Oh, no, not tarp. It's probably in props, though. It's probably in props. But wait. Have I lost my mind? Right, I'm gonna search for top. All right, top. There's the wall props. Oh wait, so they're not. The wall props aren't in the prop section. It's by the door icon. Building accessories. Oh, that might make sense. Yeah. Yeah. There you go. What's it called? Sunshade. Remember those words. I didn't see these. Sunshade. Everyone remember the word sunshade. It's the only word you're allowed to think of for the rest of the week. I am gonna miss everything. I need my human. Lie down for me, buddy. This is a 6'2" person. I base it on myself. And then because I know how big I am. Good. Bit of leg room, you know? Bit of leg room. I never have a bloody leg room. And I'm not even that tall. Like, I feel bad for people who are like 6'5" and all that kind of nonsense, because, my God, how do you live on airplanes? Sunshade! You guys. Useless, let me tell you. I need a pole, but not from Poland. This is not going to be anything fancy. It's going to be very, very, very simple. It's literally just going to be a piece of tarp hanging on a pole. I'm not really going to see it. I just want to have something in the tents that kind of makes sense for the tents. Like so. Look at that, the height of comfort. I might build a little pillow. That's about all they're gonna get, but I might give them a little pillow as well. Grab all these into a group. Does she feel like a kid? Always makes me nervous when, see, that was all split from group. What group were they in? I wasn't aware they were part of a larger group. I don't. I think we can make this into a pillow, I think. Okay. It's going to be a hollow pillow. But, you know, they're sick. They're dying. You know, that's... You know, let's get some priorities. It's curvy and it's fabric-y, it's a pillow. Or it's a death chamber, whatever you want to call it. I mean, it kind of looks like a pillow. Oh, you're part of that. Stop it. Stop it! Everything's part of the bloody... Eh. There we go, thank you. Yeah, I mean, they're just gonna sit in there, so... I actually think that looks alright. Just so it looks like people have been... lying in there, dying from dinosaur flu, or whatever the heck it is we're doing here. God only knows. I'm aware that the pillow's sticking through the thing. I do need to fix that, because it's gonna make me sad otherwise. It just moves inexplicably. I don't really have any justification for why that's done that. I'm sure I did something wrong, don't get me wrong. I really should have fixed this before I made a billion of the bloody things, but hey-ho. I think that we'll not run it. Hey, Capita. I'm not going to say that name. That's very confusing for me. Sorry. Cappy. Cappy? I'm going to call you Cappy. Like you're a captain of a little steamboat. I want the Mr. Beaumont. Pillows. There we go. Yeah, I mean, I think between those and the boxes, that's done quite a lot of good work there. We are going to do... Oh, I mean, you can just post it in here. Draw it on. If that helps. And I really want to see Dune Part 2. What am I doing with my life? I'm going to... You know, this is probably... This is going to be, like, one of the longest builds I've ever done. I think we talked about that last time, but it's going to be, like, a 10, 11-hour build for essentially a coelophysis habitat, which is... It's quite a lot by my standards. I'm going to put it all into one big video and do a time-lapse. Link here is fine. Or you can send it on Discord, with whichever's easier for you. Really, I don't really mind. Although it'll be easier for me to get to it if you just link it here, because I am not on Discord on my PC at the moment. The only other thing I really wanted to do that we haven't done yet. Is, oh god. Right, first of all, we need to put some cracks and stuff in the wall. And I want to do more moss, but I also wanted to do like a, you know, like a tunnel? Like a, you walk through and you're infected and they sort of spray you down and stuff like that. It's like a hazard tunnel. I don't know what you'd call it. But something like that. Like the kind of guy comes out of here. I don't really know how I would do that though. So let's just focus on the cracks and stuff like that. Let's grab it. You. If I was a crack, where would I be? One day I'll learn this game a little bit better. I'm getting there, slowly but surely. But I don't know where anything is. Like, if I don't know something by name, I don't stand a chance. This needs to be darker, I think. Not that dark, though. See what I mean? Like, it's light all the way to there, very small, and then, dark. It feels weird, I don't know. It's very hard to go a tiny bit darker, but not go black. Kind of what I'm looking for, I think. I'm not gonna go too crazy on these. Because they don't, I don't think they scale that well. Nah. Maybe. I'm gonna throw some cracks around. Try to hide them sort of, especially around here on the rock, that makes sense. Like, this bit on the right hasn't fallen apart, but it's tenuous. To say the least. It looks better in the light, actually. Completely the opposite to what I expected. Again, same idea. The rock, particularly over here, should be barely holding on. Okay. Oh, first, stop asking. Already answered, you numpty. Sorry, cat, if you're still listening. Let me just check this. Let's throw it on. I don't apologize for the pink. Oh, yeah, that's very helpful, thank you. Yeah, they're much nicer than mine, aren't they? Okay, maybe we can make ours a bit fancier then. Arthur, you gotta stop, man. I don't tend to remake things. I said maybe. That's it. No more, please. Yeah, I'm gonna do some. I wanna do some more moss work and stuff like that on the wall for sure, yeah. I kind of like my little thing here. I don't want to get rid of it, so maybe I won't do the, oh, actually, okay, I'm not going to do the tunnel anymore, because I don't think it's going to work anyway. Move you over there. I said maybe. That's about as good an answer as you're going to get. What I'm going to do is going to build this thing, Mr. Troodon's scent, and we're going to have that sitting here. I'll put the nesting stuff there. So the idea is that you have to walk past the coelophysis nest in order to leave, right? Just kind of pointing you a little closer to the danger zone. So I don't want more trees. Maybe. A brilliant, brilliant word. Shout out Jurassic B, yo, brap brap. Is that what you had in mind? Sorry, I'm a cocky son of I'm a sarcastic son of a bitch. I know that. It's in my blood, okay? It's not my choice. I didn't choose to be this person. Right, I'm gonna build one of these. Thanks for the links, Jordan. So we're gonna make this the coelophysis nesting area. Nice and close to the doorway. Probably a little bit too tall. What about there? Okay, I'm building the second one at the 40 sent me just for reference. Getting there, folks. It's nearly dinosaur time. Sort of. Yeah. It's gonna happen today. I mean, the actual adding the dinosaurs takes about 2 seconds. You know, it doesn't. There's no, not really any work involved in that part of the process. What's this called again? The chainmail. It's not called chainmail. It's called mesh. Nope. What's it called?
What is it called?
Maybe it's called chain. Well, this is chain. Oh, it is called chain. Chain link. That makes more sense. It's blacker than black. It's going to sit at the back. Is this wood? Yeah, it is. I'm going to have to change this. I want this to be made out of metal. I really like their world space textures they've got. World space textures they've got going on here. With the chain link and now the what's the other one? The new one that just got added. I was talking about it in my video the other bloody day. I need to change this. I need some metal. Metal. Oh, that's fine. Maybe a little bit big. I'm gonna bring that down just a little bit. That's fine. I'm gonna sneeze. Whew. Apologies. Bloody Nora. Oh, I need my phone open for this. Right. So I mean, there isn't chain link there on this, is there? No. I mean, it doesn't have to match it exactly, but probably should. So this is going to go, actually, over here. Let's bring that in. I really like the chain link, but it's very hard to work with. You just can't see what's going on. That should be about right. Bring it down low. I do like that it stretches in one direction. Much like myself. Just makes it a lot easier to work with. I know I just said it's hard to work with. Things can be two things. Okay. I'm gonna bring all this up now that I've changed how I'm doing this. You're not the same group. Nope. It's mystical, magical, floating thing. Right, so we need some supporting struts. We've got, where are my lovely jubbly things? That's very pretty. I don't know what we're ever going to use it for, but it's very pretty. I could use metal beam. I want a scaffold, I think, though. Something like that. Two-headed boy. Come on, baby. Come on. Come on. Right smack bang there in the middle. There you go. Good girl. Let's get that up there. Get the colour shifted. Can we change you colour-wise? Yeah, of course we can. Okay. Oh, God damn it. I'm so happy for a second, and then disaster. That should be on the grid, though, so it should be fine. Yeah, sweet. So this is going to be the nest for our coelophysis. This has revealed to me that that is not even... Actually, this is going to stick out a little bit. I think that's fine. More like a... So it looks a bit more like a roof. Having a little overhang on your roof is a big deal. Oh, sorry, someone asked about PZ. About how you build. I mean, I'm not really the person to ask, I retain. That my PC building skills aren't anything to write home about. But, oh man, it's a hard thing to describe. I mean, if you want to go back and look at my first stuff I worked on Planet Zoo, I was terrible. I was really bad. I really was so awful. Like, I'm not exaggerating. I was dreadful. If you look at my first park build in that game, it is atrocious. And I do think I've got a lot better. But it takes time. The main thing really is just practice. I mean, and I would make sure... Actually, the main thing, the main way to get better at Planet Zoo, in my opinion, is literally just to have a reference image. I think it's such a big deal to have a reference image to work from. You don't have to copy it exactly, but most people can't like perfectly imagine, you know, a zoo or like especially like backstage areas if you want to do that kind of thing, and you know, even just little things like rock formations, how rocks fall down, blah 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 blah, just little things like that. If you just learn from the reference images, you get a lot better. It's like learning to be an artist. You don't just stop picking up a pencil and draw. You study real life, you know, you study other artists, you study the world. And it's basically the same on Planet Zoo and Prehistoric Kingdom on anything. It's if you treat it like an art form, I'm not saying it is, but if you treat it like an art form, you'll have better results. Right. I want to add a little bit of colour. It's got like some weird colour to it. I want to try to get that in there as well. Make it a little bit more interesting. And sure, yeah, I can name a coelophysis after you. People get too down on themselves as well. Like, you look at... Because the problem is, you look at YouTubers, and I do not mean me in this, I really don't. But you look at YouTubers, like, let's say, you know, the lady, or... I've forgotten literally every single person who plays Planet Zoo. Silverette, or... Jonty, who doesn't really play the game anymore, or... Rudy's who I was trying to bloody remember. And they've been playing, you know, Planet Coaster and Planet Zoo and blah, 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 Planet Coaster for years and years, and then they moved to Planet Zoo and... You know, it's... It's just practice, man. It's just practice. And don't get too down on yourself. And I say that as someone who gets down on themselves about their Planet Zoo building guilty all the time. I think I'm happy with this. It's quite good. It's alright. It does the job. I don't think there's anything I want to change. I don't see anything I want to change. Do we have any chests or do we have barrels? Got a barrel cactus, not really the same thing. I'm gonna throw a wheelbarrow. Bam! It's like the first prop I've used. Box? Yeah, alright. Donation. Well, not donation box. At least, though. Is everything been waiting for somewhere out there? I should have a few of these lying around, actually. Like supply boxes. Just sort of strewn around the air. The shadows in this game are really funny sometimes, because look at that shadow on that box. It's illogical. It doesn't make any sense whatsoever. Why is the shadow like that? It's not float. It looks like it's floating, but it's not floating. It's very strange. It's one thing the game needs a little bit more of. They're definitely getting a lot better for it, but more just like general detritus would be great. I don't use these boxes because of that bloody effect. Oh no, bananas. The military bring bananas. That's all they brought. That's all they brought.
When is Planet Zoo coming back? You should do, Yosh. That'd be great. Planet Zoo, I have started working on the next Planet Zoo built. I'm only about an hour in. So, there's a while to go, but I have started working on it. No promises when it'll arrive, but it is in development. I'll say that much.
I don't want that to look too much like a purposeful nest, but we can kind of pretend they've gathered. Maybe that's a better idea, actually. Let me just grab some of this. I want it to feel like the troodons, or maybe troodons, the coelophysis have grabbed foliage in the area to kind of build the nest for themselves. So I don't know if I want to use the... I mean, we can just say the hay's kind of dried out over time, right? This is local foliage. It's just dried local foliage. But I want to make sure it kind of blends in with already established foliage. So we need some of this in. Love foliage hiding behind buildings. Gotta be one of my favourite genders. I'm not sure what just happened to light in that. That's bonkers. I think that's probably okay as it is, actually.
Yeah, it's fine. No worries.
Yeah, it just needs like a leafy nest material, you know, like the Planet Zoo one. Planet Zoo's got the hay one, it's also got like a leafy sort of, but I think that looks alright. A bit more moss. Yeah, the fur channel is very much in development. It's going to take a while longer. It's why I'm not talking about it really, it's just because it's going to take some time. Just is what it is. Nothing can be done. It is being worked on. Okay, I think the last thing I really want to do. Do I want to do that? I don't know if I want to do that. Oh, no, I don't. Never mind. We could have some vines hanging down it or something. I think it's alright like that. It's still a little bit much. What's this? What's this line? What are you, line? Not a clue what that is. I think it's something from the wall. I'm not sure what it is. Yeah, what are the vines I put on the, let's see. I'm trying to give myself less work. The vines have a, I guess it's alright like that, actually. It's very nice to them that they're hanging correctly. Obviously, since I said that. Why is some of them correct and some of them aren't? I'm gonna pick some different music. This is a bit depressing. Right. The main thing I want to do now is fuck up the walls, basically. And then, I think that's it. I think I'm happy past that point. I just want to rock around the base, and then we're going to attack it with some moss as well. And then I think we are done. And this is a free video for me. I mean, no, I had to work for 10 hours, but it means I can make a time lapse and upload this to the channel for everyone who doesn't watch the streams. Just a bit more rock. The walls are just, they're very large, so you need to... What if I do like... Is that going to look crazy? It's going to look crazy, yeah. Try to break up the texture a little bit more. I'll do some plants going out the cracks, as suggested. It's a good idea as well. There we go, that's a better song. I really like how this game handles the movement like this. If this is planet zoom and I was holding shift, it would go straight vertically downwards, but this is, as far as I can tell, following... Oh no, would it? Yeah, I think... No, I think it would. This is following the curvature of the wall. Good. Oh, hey Gear. Thanks, buddy. I still think Barry after escaping life and Elder was started a biotech company. Yeah, we can say that. It doesn't work for me. What do you use to make items do that?
You mean this? I'm just holding shift. The movement. I don't know if you're talking to me, but if you are talking to me, I'm just holding shift. Literally, that's it. Shift and then move your mouse downwards. We can change the colour of the moss. I'm not going to necessarily do it for this, but I'm thinking it might be good for like a... If we change it to like a red or a purple or pinkish, it might be good to do like a fake biohazard kind of thing. We could use the moss as our infectious material, basically. I like this idea, actually. It's kind of like annihilation, a little bit. And we can suggest this kind of like almost... Maybe it's not a virus, maybe it's like a fungus... Maybe we're going a bit harder on the Last of Us inspiration. And the moss is... This is like the... I guess the low-key version of it or something. The non-dangerous version that's kind of spreading, as you can see, quite prolifically on the outside of the building. But then the deeper in we get, the more hazardous the material becomes. If we change this to like... something like that. This kind of thing, you know? And it's climbing up the walls and maybe glowing slightly and all that kind of jazz. We could do like a... I don't know, I think that could be pretty interesting. The moss has this really nice vibe to it where it feels appropriate for that kind of thing.
Hey, Scott.
I'm good. How are you doing, buddy?
Are you a cat or dog person? I am more a dog person than a cat person, but I'm both. I very much like both. The last girl I dated, her cat used to come sleep on my head at night. It was very, very cute, and it reminded me how much I like cats, actually. I was kind of a cat, which unfortunately passed away fairly recently. Yeah, I like this idea a lot. This is what I mean when I talk about like building a story and stuff like that, which is something I know I care about more than most people when it comes to builds. I'm not going to pretend otherwise. But I don't tend to worry too much about it before I get started. It'll reveal itself to you. You've just got to listen. And I know that sounds pretentious, and it is a little. I'm not going to pretend otherwise. But it's true. If you just let the story come to you, it will come to you. It'll show itself to you. The story wants to be written. It wants to be discovered. You just have to give it the time to do so. I love this moss clump. I'm just going to put this out there, right? Like, I know that's obvious because I've put about 1,000 of them down, but I love this moss clump from the bottom of my heart. It is my favourite item in the entire game. Looks really good going down the rock wall as well. I need a bit more rockier on the right, actually, I think. It wasn't my pet, it was my ex-girlfriend's pet. I've not had a pet for many, many years, but I do want a dog. I may have gone a bit far on this. We're nearly there, though. We're nearly there. I mean, can you go too far? To an extent, you need to either go too far or not at all. Like, I find that when you do something by halves, in this game or in Planet Zoo or anything, really, any building game, if you start sort of half-assing it or just not pushing it too far, it doesn't look purposeful. Like, you need to go over the top to make it look like you did it on purpose sometimes. Maybe I'm talking nonsense. Well, it's worth noting, this looks demonstrably different than it did when we started today. It is very, very different. So we want to throw a crack onto over here as well. A little bit of moss as well, because I can't help myself anymore. I've got a problem. It's a moss problem. You know, it's seeping through the cracks. It's escaping through the cracks in the wall. I need more mushrooms as well. Don't we bloody all? Oh, I kind of like the idea of it. Just need to get the positioning. Try not to have it too much at the top. Like, it bursts through a little bit at the top, but it's fairly sporadic. It should feel like it's alive. It should feel like an active organism that's trying to get through and is searching for the way in. It's a bit wild, isn't it? I'm really happy with this. Oh. Except I made a mistake over here. Because it's not on an angle, it looks fake. Not a phenomenon, but very true. Nothing in real life is at a 90 degree angle, so everything needs to be curved a little bit.
Yeah, I'll go back and do that for sure. How are you able to have the moss piece snap into position?
It's just the Josh says it's just the, if you go into here and you go to this button here, the third button along or the first under surface, that stacks onto other modular items. So as you can see, as I move it along, it's kind of sticking to whatever I'm doing. So if I put it on this surface and then I hold shift to pull it downwards vertically, because the wall's at an angle, it kind of cuts in like that. Like I said, right, just had to make sure. I was pretty sure nothing was going on the other side, but I had to double check. Thanks, Northrun. I said at the start of this build, when we first began this, that I've never got Prehistoric Kingdom, in a way, in terms of building. Like, it's never clicked for me. This is the first time it has. Oh, yeah, that's a good idea, Yoshi. We'll do that. Which ones do we like? I like these ones. They've got a slightly weird feeling to them. Well, now that I think about it, I think these are probably floating. Yes, they are. Of course they bloody are. Aren't they always? But I mean, if anything, like, I mean, at the end of the day, that's kind of proving my point. You know, if you're like, oh, I wish I could build, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, well, I was terrible at this game. Like, I've still got a long way to go. You just gotta keep going, man. All you can do is keep going. And get better over time. And I've used a lot of reference images, which has really helped. I do want to put more moss and stuff around there, but I don't know. Maybe we shouldn't, because I've made the moss into like a mystical magical monster. I think we're done. I think it actually is finished. What a weird world we live in. I don't know Olivia, okay? That's the other problem. I don't know. I'm hoping, I don't know if this works, but will the habitat marker keep dinosaurs contained? Tell you what, we can do a test. Okay, that doesn't work. Safe to say.
Watch out! Here comes the shark lizard, Carcharodontosaurus. Carcharodontosaurus gets its name from its teeth.
And also, don't give up when things look rough. And you remember, I mean, much I was quite happy with what we built last video. And then I look at this and I'm like, well, no, actually, it looked terrible. No, humans! Humans! Oh, because I had a dinosaur. Get out of my park. Go away. Not ready. How do I close? I know they changed it this week. That there's now a way to shut your park, but I don't know how you do it. Or does anyone know? No, I don't think it's an option. Get out of my park! How do I shut my park? Management view, that's gotta be it. There we go. Yeah, I figured that's what it did, but I just wanted to give it a shot. We also need to rename. Parque Hugo. So the question is, how do we keep the coelophysis in here? My only inclination is that if I give the food in this area, they'll stay here, right? I guess they can wander around all they want, but they should keep coming back to the area where the food is. And I guess that's okay. So I'm going to put a feeder in. Needs a path connection. No, it doesn't. Shut up. Why there's a mountain of meat is irrelevant. I've got to be able to hide that somehow, right? Be gone. Okay, one sec. I don't want to see that. The problem is, if I put anything down by the gate, you won't be able to walk through. That's the issue. Like, you won't be able to walk through the gate if it's able to keep the dinosaurs contained. That's why I was hoping the invisible fence would do it. I can't have this here if it's going to have that stupid bloody thing. Welfare's not even on. And infinite food is on, so why would it matter? It doesn't matter. Did I have music turned off? I didn't realise. Sorry about that. There you go. Tell me if that's too loud. I don't think there's a way to turn that off. I don't want to look at that all day, you know what I mean? But the point is, if I put anything here, the humans won't be able to walk through. Which isn't necessarily a big deal. But it kind of is. I mean, the thing is, I want to be able to walk through the park, right? As a human. But I mean, we could stack some rocks in here. We could say there's a rock fall. And we could just... I don't care about guests walking through necessarily, I suppose. I'm never going to have guests walking around because it doesn't suit what the park is anyway. So we could do a rock wall. And then what we can do is when we come to walk through it ourselves, we can pretend we're just like, you know, clambering over it, I suppose, to get inside. Yeah, I can do that. I can, that's fine. I can justify that, no problem. So we need some rocks in the area. Actually, we probably want some slightly bigger rocks here. Build the wall. Don't worry too much about what the wall looks like initially, like I say. Get the basic shape down. I can now contain them. Maybe. Where's my lovely baby bits? That's my lovely babies. I always say, get the basic shape down with your rock first. And then go in again and add detail. And make it look less homogenous. Especially angle this rock and you can really make it look like a bit of a rock fall sort of situation. Covering a bit of foliage as well. What I should have done is put this in a separate group so I could get rid of it later on if need be. That was silly. Not totally convinced this is going to contain them, but we'll find out. Still a little bit too noticeable for my liking. It's gonna be hard to make it not without having quadrillions of rocks. I don't mind having quadrillions of rocks. I don't know where the rocks came from. Does that matter? Does that really matter? I don't know if that really matters. So it can be more staggered on this side, because the silos aren't on this side. Eh. It's alright. I love the soundtrack for this game, what do you mean? See you, Northrend. So, I mean, the problem with a truck is that I do want it to be something that I could feasibly climb over as a human, you know what I mean? Need this to, this is looking too flat. So I want to be able to justify how I get into the park. I don't care if my guests can get into the park. I need to be able to get into the park, though, in a realistic way. It's kind of like... So I know I'm all about no realism, just vibes. It's very much a thing. I do think people can get too hampered by trying to build realistically. But it's kind of like building a video game. Like, you can have magic, you can have weird things, you can have whatever you want, but your game world should be internally consistent. At the end of the day, I can climb over certain things, I can't climb over certain things. Like, I know we're in this weird post-apocalyptic dinosaur world, so it doesn't necessarily make a lot of sense, but rocks and climbing things and doors all work the same way, because that's how they work in reality. And they're real things, so we can't just ignore how they function. And I know none of that is really important for building a dinosaur park, but it's the kind of things that I enjoy thinking about. Need a bit more rock in the area just to kind of make it a bit less noticeable. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they're just going to run away. But it is what it is. I don't want to mess around with this too long. That's not really a big concern area. I've got some mushrooms. Right. So the last thing, two things I want to fix then. Right, first of all, let's go to this because that's going to really annoy me. Thank you. Let's grab some silos, and we'll see what they do. Let's see what they do. If I was a silo, where would I be? I would be there. I don't think I want the feathered ones, you know. I think I want the two unfeathered ones. I just think that makes stylistically more sense. Oh, well, do you see insect feeder instead as well? What a beaut. Is that too many? Nah. Nah. Alright. Speed? Where do they go? Oh, wait. they can just walk out of here. No, stop. Desist. Right. I'm gonna have to... that's fine. Let's just watch them for a minute and see where they go. Walk through my... there they go. Okay, they seem to struggle. Okay, so they can get there, but they can't do anything when they get there. So we just need to maybe make a little change in this corner.
Coelophysis is without a doubt the most iconic dinosaur of the Triassic period. Just like how many Hollywood icons have left their handprints behind in concrete at the famous Chinese theater, many fossilized footprints known as grallata have been attributed to Coelophysis. It must have been quite a celebrity back in the day.
It's a weird little corner, you're never gonna see it. Wait, does the game actually have navmesh? I didn't even realise. How do you check navmesh? Can you do navmesh on this game? Are you sure? Why is this different? It's not how I remember this being. Oh, God. I'm hoping if I put the feeder in and we just deal with the stupid icon until there's a way to get rid of it, then they won't leave because they've got delicious food, you know? And if I give them some insects, I can kind of blend it in a little bit better. Oh, hey, he's not shouting at me. Nice. You wouldn't want to leave, right? You got food over here. Management view. Click the eye. What? Management view is the eye. Oh, this one. Ha! See, look at that! What are you all worried about? Perfectly contained. Look at that! Don't know what I'm going to do about this one. We'll have to just do the same idea. I'll, like, lean the door against it or something. Oh, they really saw the one gap and really went for it. Alright. Well, I said I would name... Is it North Irin or North... I think it's North Irin, right? No. Life finds a way. That's how I feel about this. Well, let's see. Does that mean it's still gonna work? Seems to still work. Oh, for you're a girl, I'm sorry. Ceci, who wants to be Ceci? Troodon helped me. Can I call the seal of faces Troodon? Sure, there you go. Offering, Sagasol, Arthur, Joshua. I don't know if there's any others. Throw it on. Should be a couple more out there somewhere. God knows where they are, though. Oh, what are you doing? I'm watching. No, that's a wall. I don't know if I have any more. I swear I should have several. Is there a way to just see the dinosaurs? Did I pay 8? Where are they all gone? I can find the same 5 over and over again. The others have done a goddamn runner. It might not be enough, actually. They're kind of cute, though, aren't they? Together like this. Oh, I might put a light in this as well, actually. I'm going to crop one of these lights over here. Oh, you're off. Interesting. So I grab one of these. Oh, who's this? Oh, it's Troodon. Cheeky little blighter. As he is. She is, I suppose. Coelophysis says trans rights. Why are you not rotating? Why do you hate me? Sometimes you just need to actually go into the group. What the heck in heck? Bear with me. What the hell? Can anyone... What? I know it's not perfect. What? Wait, let me... Okay. It's fine. God damn it, I'm falling apart. This is wild. I think I'm clicking the wrong thing. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm doing something terrible. To sound like me, to be fair. Come on, stop. Cute. Spooky. All right, cool. So let's do a final little run through. You know what, I'll add a couple more, because two of them have done a runner away. I literally don't know where they are. Everyone's gonna be at loss, though.
Who wanted to be in it?
Pies. Is it T-H-I-J-S, yeah?
It's almost certain that it's also the trickiest dinosaur name to say. If you ever have some time on your hands, I recommend listening to the visitors. Try to sound out its name. Coelophysis never fails to make me smile.
No. Can't spell. Okay, so let's do a little run through. We'll do a daytime and a nighttime, I suppose. Cannot believe how long this build took. Okay, so we spawn, as we all want to do, in a shed. La bunker. You walk down the nature trail. Wow, I love nature. Those are the kind of things you'll be saying, because you love nature. Maybe you stop over at the emergency box, which does say emergency on it. You just have to get very close. You stop off at the emergency box for emergency things. And you carry on walking. And you're like, whoa, that's a big skull. Because you don't see the skull. That's very important. You don't see the skull at this point until you round the corner. Then you're like, uh-oh, something's going on here. And then you round the corner a little bit more. And you kind of get a little glimpse of something in the distance, but you're not sure what it is. But you see the lovely log with lovely mushrooms and a lovely Arthropleura greeting you. And then that's kind of like the second gateway. I need to do a bit more work here, I think. It's got the vibe I wanted, I'll say that much. So you clamber over the rock. Bleh, bleh, bleh. Like, uh-oh, dinosaurs. You say it in that voice because you're a cool kid. And then you float for some reason. Because I forgot the button to, is it T? Yeah. I'm watching you, bucko. I don't know how I would post this on the workshop, but to be honest, like, I don't know. I'm gonna put some foliage hanging down there as well. Like, I'd have to do the whole thing on. I might just post the entire zoo on the workshop when it's done. Well, pressing T really makes a big difference. I can just walk around if I press T. I'm pretty happy with it, yeah. It's definitely, when I envisioned it, this is kind of what my mind's eye was picturing, you know? Guys. And eventually, we'll head down there. But not yet. Into the very mossy bit. And then the infection will start to spread. And one little run through at night time as well, because we are putting the work in to make sure it looks good at night. What the hell? I've killed my flashlight somehow. Not sure how, but I've killed my flashlight. Bear with me. I did save it, didn't I, the flashlight? Oh, I didn't save the... Oh, no! My flashlight! I've deleted it somehow. Must have been when I was grabbing the thing from it earlier. Oh, man. I'm going to have to make another flashlight. Oh, I didn't save it. Some thing. Actually, what we're going to do? We're going to save my... We're going to make a new save. And we're going to load the old Ooga Bugge. Actually, this will be good. Because what we can do is... So this is what it looks like now. Put it into your mind's eye. Okay. Is it in there? Load it in, right? Keep it in there. In your brain. In your brain hole. I'll do it later. Fine. And what we'll do is we'll load up. I've still got the old save file, so I should be able to load in and rescue it, in theory.
Yeah, we're just about to end for him. We're just finishing some things off. When will your next live stream? Next Friday. It's every Friday at 7 UK time. Is the idea. Turns out if I have a gas leak in my house again, you know?
And we do indeed have dinosaurs. Yeah, I think it's safe to say it's come a long way today. It's kind of wild, actually, looking at what it looks like now. It's crazy. Right, where's my flashlight? Hello, beautiful. I can't seem to grab. I guess I don't need it. How I delete this. Okay, and then we load back in. It is indeed getting a Godzilla DLC. I'm quite excited about it. Day of the Diver ends on Monday. Only doing one more episode. Don't know what I'm playing next. Not a bloody clue. Right. Glory! Lovely. Okay, so let's go do the nighttime tour. You are born, as you are, in a shed. As we all want to be, you're born in a shed. Suspicious red lights. And you're around the corner. Yeah, that second restaurant was very strange. This is still my favourite shot in the entire thing, I'm not gonna lie. This right here is my favourite angle, my favourite shot. Just cause I think it's just so atmospheric. And it looks like Alan Wake, that makes me happy. Even better now that we've got this new foliage on the floor. Walking along. And then you're going to round the corner again. This time, bomb, bomb, bomb. And you get that gleam of red in the distance as well, which is cool. All right, someone's dropped to their flashlight. We might throw a few flashlights in here as well. We could use that. Maybe in a couple of the tents. Get some lights in here. We'll see how it looks at night. And you're walking. You're walking. Say hi to Alpha Plura. Hi, Alpha Plura. Alpha Plura needs a name. Dom, dom, dom. Is this too red? Eh. You climb through the red light. The red light is your... Oh, you know what? I think it's a bug, but that flicker is awesome. That makes me very... That is great. I'm just going to big myself up. That looks awesome. Ignore the flicker, which I don't know why the flicker is happening. But that is a hell of a view. I want the Coelophysis to run along again. That was what's made me happy. Why is this flickering now? What's flickering? Which one of you is flickering? Something over here. Is it me? Am I flickering? I'm the flicker. Why am I the flicker? I am the flicker. How weird. Entering the red light district, yeah. Why am I the... Oh, there it is. Hello. I just think that's a fantastic view. With the gate looming up ahead of you, the large gate. You can see the entrance just there on the left. Various different lights and shades going on. The spotlights. Every now and again, you see a Coelophysis dart across in the distance. I'm pretty chuffed with this, yeah. And your credit to PK, I don't think you could build this in any other game. I think this is the only game in the world you could build this in. I guess in theory you could do it in Planet Zoo, but it would take you a gajillion years. It really would. Man, the scene of Coelophysis is catching in the light in the distance. And it's definitely for my character, because look, it's not there at the moment in the trees. It's something about my character interacting with one of these lights. I mean, I don't hate it. It looks alright to me. It's got like horror vibes. If I could have flickering lights, I would absolutely have some flickering lights. I actually can't hear the Coelophysis, but I'll take your word for it. But this is what I like. I like framing, and I like... You know, the car there, you can see the number, you can see the tents on both sides, you can see some of the cracks, you can see the moss crawling up. It's just, it's got everything, you know? Anyways, you clamber over. Yeah, so I think maybe a torch in one of these. It's a shadow problem, yeah. I think maybe a torch in... Let me see if I can fix this. One sec, it's really going to annoy me. Well, that made it worse. Okay. It's something about the high-quality shadows. Has that fixed it entirely? Yeah, it's something about the high-quality shadows. Alright, I'll leave them off for now then. I think we put the flashlight in one of these tents. I want to have a little bit more moss crawling up on the wall, but I do want most of it around the doorway. I want it to feel like you're entering where it's come from, you know? I want it to feel like that. Still not sure on this spotlight, but I do think we need some light sources in here. Yeah, I don't know what to say. I'm pretty chuffed. Just trying to get some nice views. All right, let me throw a flashlight in. Like that. Just as a little light from one of them. I might change that up a little bit. There's a couple little things I want to do. Now, funny thing is, this took ages, but this was the easy bit. this was very much the easy part. Because next video then, we go through this door over here. We'll have to block this off. And then you enter this. This was, you know, it's small and self-contained. I can't get away with that forever. So it's going to start opening up to that world, and that's terrifying. We're just going to go exhibit by exhibit, design by design, and hopefully come up with some cool stuff. Yeah, you know, this is 11, 12 hours work or something stupid, but I do think it was worth it. I think it's the best thing I've ever built in Prehistoric Kingdom by an absolute mile. I don't think it's even close. It's not even slightly close. It's a gajillion miles away, which is because I like this, but also a damning indictment of everything else I've ever built in this game, which has always been fairly awful, it must be said. Hey, Alpha. I'm nervous about the next one, though. I really am. I'm going to have to do some planning over the next week. Decide how I'm going to... how I'm going to develop the next area. Because that's going to be the big challenge. I don't have a great plan right now. But we'll come up with something. Right, we are going to end it there, then. So thank you very much, everyone who joined me. I might do a little bit of work for next week, or we might just do it in the video, in the stream next week, I should say. Because there's just a couple little things I want to do on the walls. But, I don't like how straight that looks. That's better. Yeah, cool. So, let's get this saved. I will say the game's handling it as well. The game's handling it nicely. There's a lot of stuff here, but the game is not having any problems so far. Yeah, thank you for everyone who joined me, for everyone who gave advice and suggestions. Hope you had a good time. Like I said, you will probably see this build on the channel next week, now that we have a dinosaur in it, you know? But I'll voice over the whole thing, so, you know, there'll at least be something new to talk about. Thank you, guys. Yeah, you've been a big... part of the build so far. Troodon in particular, you've been immensely helpful, so I appreciate that. But all of you, you know, I think had suggestions from about 20 different people that have been integrated in some way, so very much appreciated. Right. Yeah, my most popular video is Alien vs. Predator. It's wild. Man. Wait. Right, thank you for joining me, and I'll see you next Friday. I'll have a video up tomorrow as well, so feel free to come back for that. Bye.